TNT presents Super Football Saturday. Today, it's an SEC matchup as the Bulldogs of Mississippi State take on the Rebels of Ole Miss. Today's game is being brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealers, who invite you to come see the 1987 Ford cars and trucks. Have you driven a Ford lately?
Live from Memorial Stadium in Jackson, Mississippi, it is 48 degrees. It is raining. Thunderstorms are on the way. Winds are gusting at 25 miles an hour. And it's perfect weather for the 83rd meeting between the Rebels of Ole Miss and the Bulldogs from Mississippi State. Good afternoon, everybody. Tim Foley and I are huddled together in our booth here high above the stadium because the rain is driving down right now, and we wanted to stay as dry as possible to prevent any kind of major illness during the telecast today. It's a great day for a football game. This is natural turf out here. It's going to be muddy and slipping and sliding, and if you like that kind of old-fashioned rocking, socking football, you'll like it. Let's go right to the weather situation. What kind of effect will it have on the game today?
Well, if you're from Nuevo, Michigan, it probably wouldn't bother you at all. But these two teams aren't used to this cold rain, I don't think. And what weather like this usually has a tendency to do is be a great equalizer, and it will reduce some of the quickness, cause Mississippi to run the football, which they've been doing successfully for the last couple of weeks. And it might slow down Don Smith a little bit, Mississippi State.
Speaking of that, Ole Miss, one of the best defenses in the Southeastern Conference. And how are they going to match up against this Don Smith-led Mississippi State offense?
Well, it really is Don Smith. SDS is the term that they're talking about.
Political
this week.
Action
yeah,
group.
Yeah, that, back in the old days, that's what it was. Now it means stop Don Smith. And folks have been successful doing that in the last few weeks. Obviously, Alabama, Auburn, LSU, good defenses. But what they've gone to now is against Don Smith, just a base defense, prevent the big play. We saw Don against Tennessee, broke a 74-yarder at the end of the game to really win the game for Mississippi State. And what you've got to do with Don Smith is prevent that big ripoff.
If Don Smith gets more than 277 yards in total offense today, he will become the all-time total offense leader in the history of the Southeast Conference. It could happen. If you saw earlier, he was averaging about 222 yards, so a good day, and he could go past that and certainly become a historic occasion for Don Smith. Both of these programs have had disappointing closing to the season, but they perform better than most expectation. The winner will have 7 wins and will be on their way to a bowl. So it's a big game today. They call it the Egg Bowl here, interstate rivalry, and we're set to get underway right after we return back to our studios in Atlanta and Kevin Slate.
Let's go back to Jackson, Mississippi.
Well, it is a gray, wet day here in Jackson. Temperature started out 52 degrees about 45 minutes ago. It has now dropped down to 48 degrees and is said to be falling faster. There are thunderstorms on the horizon, and we've had a driving rain. The rain has lessened just a bit here prior to kickoff, but this field of natural surface is used for not only college football. We brought you the Ole Miss-Tennessee game just last week here from Jackson, but also high school games, and it's worn out. It'll be very muddy. Here come the Rebels from Ole Miss, 6-3-1. They lost a big one to Tennessee last week. They had been considered for the Bluebonnet Bowl, the Liberty Bowl, and there are still some slight possibilities there. The winner of this game will most probably, however, go to the Independence Bowl in Shreveport, Louisiana, and it's been quite a while since these teams have gone bowling. So for the Rebels of Ole Miss, it's a big game, as it is for Mississippi State's Bulldogs. They are 6-4, off to a great start in the SEC, but then losers of their last three games to LSU, Alabama, and Auburn. It's been a very good season overall, however, for first-year coach Rocky Belker. And there goes Bully, the Mississippi State Bulldog mascot. The rain doesn't seem to bother him at all. We'll find out who the Mudders are when we return to Memorial Stadium.
Here comes the little.
They call this the Egg Bowl. This series started in 1901, but it was so bloody. There were so many fights between players and students and fans that both schools got together and decided that maybe if they could award a trophy of some nature, it could calm this series down. And so they made a gold-shaped football back in 1927, and that's why they call this the Egg Bowl. The winner gets that trophy. Rivalry remains intense. This game is underway. The ball down to the 10-yard line to Michael Robinson. Down to the 30-yard line. Bill Smith, the kicker for Ole Miss, made the tackle. And Mississippi State goes on offense after the 25-yard return. Don Smith, 277 yards away from becoming the all-time total offense leader in the history of the Southeastern Conference, and a supporting cast that needs to play better for him to be able to be a successful leader of this team. An offensive line that's been beset by injuries. Tom Goode is the best player there at the center, but that has been a problem for this football team, injuries to the Mississippi State offensive line. First down, 10 Bulldogs from the 30. About 5 yards for 21, Rodney Peters, the junior out of Tucker. He was tackled by number 80, Wesley Walls, the defensive left end. You'll notice Lester Brinkley's name at left tackle. Brinkley has moved in place of Mike Fitzsimmons, the defensive leader, who is injured. He is playing with a pinched nerve. We'll probably see Fitzsimmons some. Harrod, the leading tackler on the team at the linebacker position. Jeff Noblin, an academic All-American and a scholar athlete, is the leader of the secondary for Ole Miss. Buckles. Second down and five. The ball came loose. Ole Miss has it. Jeff Patton was the ball carrier. It came loose. Ole Miss came up with the football. Jeff Noblin.
Little option here, Bob. Mississippi obviously concerned about Don Smith. Big hit knocking that ball loose by Lopez Jones. Noblin covers the ball. Big break for Mississippi early in the game.
Well, you said this rain would be an early factor, and in fact, the mud and slippery conditions have caused a turnover. From the 38-yard line, first down, 10, Ole Miss. Handoff goes to 46, Sean Sykes. Knocked out of bounds at the 32-yard line by number 4, Bruce Plummer. So the Ole Miss offensive team, led by number 14, Mark Young, their big play threat is J.R. Ambrose, but he has not been making as many big plays as they need out of him late in the season. Mark Young, however, is improving as a young quarterback, particularly in the passing game. Ricky Myers is playing against his brother, Jerry Myers, who's a wide receiver for Mississippi State. The bookend tackles for the Ole Miss offensive line, a pretty good offensive line, particularly when they run the ball. Second down, 4 from the 32-yard line. Sykes again. First down inside the 20. Plummer with the stop again. Here's that Mississippi State defense, and they just gave up 12 yards on that run, and they are vulnerable against the run. The big burden of responsibility on the shoulder of Gary Frank. He weighs 295 pounds, but he's a new nose guard as of this year, and he's had problems there. The linebackers, led by Cedric Corse, who is the leading tackler on this team. Asa Bennett has been playing very well. He's a redshirt freshman from Madisonville, Texas. First down, 10, Ole Miss. Sykes for the third straight time. Breaks the tackle, breaks two tackles. And he's knocked out of bounds at the 13-yard line by number 4, Bruce Plummer. So it's been Sykes against Plummer early in his ballgame.
And Mickles doing a fine job as a lead blocker. All three plays, Joe Mickles leading the way for Sean Sykes. That time, Jeremiah Sangster broke through, almost had a chance to make the play in the backfield, but Sykes broke the tackle and got the first down.
Sean Sykes had been the starter at tailback, was injured early. Willie Goodloe had moved in. Sykes is getting better physically and is now playing more out of the backfield position. Second down, 3 from the 13. Hand off to 41, Mickles. To the 10, no more. He's very close to the first down. Ole Miss threatening after the fumble. They recovered at the 38, and they've driven now to the 10-yard line.
And I think a great job has been done later in the year by Robert McGraw working with this offensive line for Ole Miss, because Goff and Adamsek and Derek King, that time moving back that Mississippi State front four. They did the same thing last week to Tennessee and in the first half against LSU.
Short of the first down, third down, less than a yard at the 10. Opening moments of play for Memorial Stadium. Mark Young on the option. He's hit in the backfield. And dropped for a loss by number 40, Jeremiah Sangster of Mississippi State. And we'll have a field goal opportunity for the Ole Miss Rebels.
This one a little slow developing. They ride Mickles into the line, and here comes Young trying to turn the corner. Can't really get it turned in time before Sangster catches it from behind.
Brian Owen will kick from the 19-yard line. That makes it a 29-yard field goal attempt. You see there, from the 20 to 29, he's 2 out of 3. Got his leg into that one pretty well, but it does not hook in. It stays wide to the right. And the Bulldogs of Mississippi State have dodged a bullet early after the turnover. The Rebels drive down to the 10 and Stahl missed the field goal. The game remains scoreless. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT. Welcome back to cold, rainy Jackson, Mississippi. Rain has let up just a little bit, but it's still falling steadily right now. It is Mississippi State football at the 20-yard line of the Bulldogs. This game tied, nothing, nothing. A 29-yard field goal attempt went awry, and it remains tied. 12-19 to go, first quarter of play. Bulldogs from their own 20. The handoff right up the middle out to the 25-yard line goes to Marvin McKelpin. Let me just explain something about the backs here. Mississippi State, you take a look at our booth right above us. I'll get to the backs in a minute. Right up here is a wasp's nest. And I don't mean the sociological wasp's nest. These are actual bugs with stingers.
That big.
And so we have some difficult conditions here in the booth. But, Tim, anybody can do a game in nice weather.
Right, yeah. We've knocked down 10 so far.
Just as we thought the weather was a problem, the Wasps came along. Well, we hope they enjoy the game too. Second down, five. Out to about the 29. Looked like that ball came loose. They stop him, Calvin Robinson, number 33. What I was about to say about the running backs is you're going to see at the fullback position for Mississippi State, 33 Robinson, 28 Taylor, 30 Patton, 37 McKelvin. They haven't found the player there. The running back situation for Mississippi State is not good. It's one of the reasons teams have been able to stop Don Smith.
The other reason is they've had, as you mentioned in the opening, Bob, just a
plethora.
A plethora, thank you, of injuries in the offensive line.
First down, four. Here's Don Smith going for the first down and getting it. Got a good block. Out of bounds at the 32-and-a-half-yard line. Senior quarterback Don Smith. That's a first down for the Bulldogs to the 32.
And he has showed remarkable endurance and durability during his four-year career. As you watch here, as Peters cuts down Jeff Harrod, Don Smith takes shot after shot. You watch Jeff Harrod moving to the ball. He's averaged 15 tackles a game over the last 13 games. Just an iron man for Mississippi.
McKelvin 37 and 21 Peters in the backfield for the Bulldogs. First down from the 32. They hand to McKelvin. Gets to the 35, and he's stacked up by the Ole Miss defensive line. Aided first by 66, Jeff Harrod. Lester Brinkley is playing in there at left tackle in place of the injured Mike Fitzsimmons, has a pinched nerve. Now, we'll probably see Fitzsimmons play some, as we understand, but he's really a leader. There you see McKelvin limping off the field for Mississippi State.
Also, you'll see Tony Bennett in there, who has been really playing a stand-up defensive end for Mississippi, playing right tackle. They feel like he's got the strength to hold his own in there, plus he's got the quickness to chase Don Smith.
Second down, seven. Penalty marker down. And Don Smith is down at about the 37. But there was contact. Darryl Smith was the guy who came across the line, the nose guard, 53, offsides against Ole Miss. That'll make it second down and just a couple to go for a first down for the Bulldogs. Well, the Bulldogs got off to a start, a very sloppy start here, when they fumbled the football at their own 38. Ole Miss drove it right downfield with the running of Sean Sykes to the 10. The Bulldogs' defense stiffened, and then a 29-yard field goal attempt was missed by Brian Owen. This game remains tied with 10:20 to go, quarter number one from Jackson.
Obviously, they use new balls in these games, Bob, and there's kind of a protective coating on most footballs that when it gets wet, the ball really gets slick. And as the game goes on, that tends to wear off, and sometimes you actually have a better chance to hold on to the football later on in the game.
Second down two from the 40. And the whistle sounded again before the play started. That was number 30, Jeff Patton, carrying the ball off right tackle. Let's see what the officials are going to say about that. There's Billy Brewer, the back of his head, the head coach at Ole Miss in 83, was coach of the year. Got a shot at being coach of the year again if he can win this game and then win a bowl game.
Offense, interior line move.
So that's what happened, a false start, as you heard from the referee. It's Rom Gilbert, by the way, today, in the white hat. False start on the offense. They give back the five they got on the offside from Ole Miss. You're going to see a lot of that today because of the conditions on this field. Second and seven now. Don Smith on the option. Ole Miss saw it all the way. A loss of a couple. eight red jerseys, nine red jerseys around the ball. Wesley Walls was the tackler, a penalty marker down again.
Watch Rodney Lowe, number 31, moving toward the ball. Good penetration upfield. Lester Brinkley, number 98, keeps his feet, and that's really the key. He didn't let Don Smith turn it upfield when he wanted to, and then the rest of that hustling Ole Miss defense arrived.
Now number 71, Mike Fitzsimmons, has entered the game at the defensive left tackle spot. He's really the spark plug of the Ole Miss defensive team. There you see him, 71, playing with a pinched nerve from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Mike hasn't practiced the last 2 weeks. They weren't sure whether he could play last week against Tennessee. And a competitor like, you know, I mean.
Offense, decline, third down.
You know, Mike could play if he had a broken shoulder. He's got that kind of a heart. But sometimes you put yourself in a situation where you're really not helping your team by playing if you can't perform up to the expectations that the folks have of you. But Mike's that kind of competitor, and he's going to be in there as much as he can.
Third down, eight, after the holding penalty was declined by Ole Miss from the 34. Bulldogs. Sprint out by Smith. Wants to tuck it and run. Does so to the 40. He's 3 yards shy of the first down, and the Ole Miss defense is held again. Tackle led by 35, Jeff Noblin, and the Bulldogs will have to punt it away. Willie Goodloe will go back to take it for Ole Miss. Freshman, true freshman, Tommy Parks comes in to punt. Houston, Mississippi. It's fourth down two, fourth and three, really, at the 40. This freshman's a very good punter. He's inconsistent, as you can see, however. Shanks this one, gets a good bounce for the Bulldogs, and it rolls dead at the 26-and-a-half-yard line. There, the Ole Miss Rebels will take over on offense. Only a 34-yard punt. The game remains scoreless with 8:35 to go. Quarter number one from Memorial Stadium, Jackson, Mississippi. Well, you think the weather's bad today? It was similar in 1983. The Egg Bowl from Mississippi State ran out to a 23-7 lead in the third, but Ole Miss, aided by the passing combination of Kelly Powell to Timmy Moffitt, rallied with 17 straight points to take a 24-23 lead. State got one last shot, though. Artie Cosby kicks the field goal, but no, the wind blows it back onto the field, and Ole Miss's victory is preserved 24-23, and they head to the Independence Bowl. That's the trophy for these teams today. In addition to the Egg Bowl trophy, that's a trip to the Independence Bowl for the winner here today. On first down, up the middle of the 33-yard line goes 24, Willie Goodloe. He's tackled by 92, Anthony Butts, and the rain picking up intensity once again, coming down in driving sheets now. And interestingly enough, Tim, about 50,000 seats were sold for this game. Most of the folks are here. Despite the weather.
Despite the weather, there's so much emotion involved in these games. You know, Mississippi State, they've been defeated the last 3 years. They want to see a victory. They think they've got a chance today.
Second down five from the 32. Here comes Goodloe, gets a block. The defensive player who made the stop came off the block. That was 59, Jerry Leggett. He was blocked out of the play, fought across it, and made the tackle on Goodloe.
Watch this again. Mickles has been doing a good job of getting that contained man on the ground. You see number 41 there on the right side of your screen. Fires off the ball. Good movement by the offensive line, but as you mentioned, Bob, Leggett kept his feet and got that lateral pursuit. Was in on the tackle.
Third and three out of the wishbone, full house. And off to Goodloe. Nice opening. Gets the first down to the 39-yard line. James Williams, 38, and number 7, Kirby Jackson, combine on the tackle for the Mississippi State Bulldogs. There has not been a pass thrown or a pass attempted in this ballgame thus far, for obvious reasons, I guess, with the weather being the way it is.
If Noah had a team, I don't think he'd have thrown much either, and I think that's kind of the situation out there right now.
I always thought Noah should have had a team. He had, plenty of good recruits. First and 10 from the 40. Here's Goodloe, another good opening. He was tripped up at the line or might have gone for more. Out to the 47, 48-yard line. Jerry Leggett tripping him up, number 59. Just short of the first down.
The Lightning. Mississippi likes to run to the right. With Adamczyk and Todd Irvin, they like to put Mario Perry on there. They feel like they've got some good strength, good movement over there.
6:42 to go, first quarter. Scoreless football game. Ole Miss and Mississippi State from Jackson. It is second down two. This time, number 92, Anthony Butts, wraps up Willie Goodlow. He is short of the first down.
You know, Mississippi State's defense has been much maligned over the past 3 weeks, but they've played some awfully difficult offensive football teams, powerful offensive football teams in LSU, Auburn, and Alabama. They're outsized and out-experienced up front, and they really don't have any depth. So all those things are working against Bobby Wallace, the defensive coordinator at Mississippi State.
40 Dentley, 41 Mickles in the backfield. They block. They give it to 24 Goodlow. First down, Ole Miss. Running successfully to the 46-yard line. Kirby Jackson with the tackle. Let's go back to Atlanta now and Kevin Sleet.
All right, Bob, perhaps Bo Schembechler won't get the choice to go for 2 points this week. Watch Vinnie Workman cut back against the grain. 46 yards later, touchdown Ohio State. They are out in front of Michigan now, 14-3, and they're really putting it on them. Let's go back to Jackson.
Well, there, from a Michigan point of view, that wasn't much fun to watch. First down 10 from the 46, Sean Sykes. Standing bounds. Hall out of bounds at the 4-yard line. Milton Smith caught him, but Sykes turned the corner and tight-roped it down the sideline for 41 yards.
We're just talking about Joe Mickles, Mario Perry. Going to see 72, Adam Seck pulling around there. Irvin gets the block. The Mississippi State defender comes inside, a missed block by the safety, and here goes Sean Sykes. Watch Joe Mickles, number 41, leading the way, gets the double team with Perio. And then it's off to the races for Sean.
Ole Miss was stopped earlier at the 10, but now it's first and goal at the 4. Full house backfield. 40 Dentley's the big guy. They give it to Sykes. He rams the right side for about a yard. Jackson there to make the stop of number 46, Sean Sykes. Sykes stacking up some yardage here in 5 carries, 69 yards for Sykes. Ole Miss has run for 97 already. We're going to pause 5 seconds to allow our local stations to identify themselves.
You're watching Superstation WTBS, Atlanta.
Second and goal from the 3. Willie Green, number 1, splits wide to the left off your screen. Other than that, it's a straight T formation in the backfield. Ambrose goes in motion from the right halfback spot. They give to Goodlow. Touchdown, Ole Miss.
Once again, Ole Miss running to their strength, running to the right. Good penetration by Butts. Course can't quite get there in time. Goodlow keeps his footing. Touchdown, Ole Miss.
Willie Goodlow, who was the backup tailback, took the job over when Sean Sykes was injured, and he came in after Sykes got him down there. The point after attempt by Brian Owen is good. Sykes ran it 46 yards to get him down on the doorstep. And then opening the door and taking it into the end zone was Willie Goodlow. 7-0 Ole Miss, 4:45 to go. First quarter. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT. Ole Miss leads 7-0, and the Mississippi State defense having to try to get their act together there, Tim.
One thing that's going to help them get their act together is the offseason. They need to get a little bit bigger and stronger, and they're going to get some more players. I'm sure Rocky will try to get a couple of junior college kids in to try to bolster that defensive strength.
Michael Robinson, 36, at the 5. Down to the 23-yard line goes Robinson. 4:39 to go first quarter. Rebels lead by a score of 7-0. And when you were looking at the statistics of that Ole Miss drive, 73 yards, not one pass thrown. And that reminds me of the Alabama-Mississippi State game, Tim, when Alabama scored without throwing a single pass on 3 consecutive drives at the opening of the ballgame.
Exactly. And it was the same thing against Auburn and LSU. And you can only plan around so many deficiencies, and they've got a lot of young players playing on defense. They're scrappy, they're fighters, but they're just outgunned right now.
Let's see if Don Smith can get something going offensively. No. Down hard is Calvin Robinson. He was met head up by Robert Smith. Scores around the country. Boston College, Holy Cross all nodded. Holy Cross, as you know, undefeated right now. Georgia Tech having no problem with Wake Forest. We'll be seeing Georgia Tech playing Georgia on our telecast next week. Penn State just barely in front of Pittsburgh. And, of course, people at the Orange Bowl are pulling for Pittsburgh. Michigan State and Wisconsin tied at 7 in the first quarter. Second down, 9, the 24. Number 30 is Patton. Not much. About the 26-yard line, Jeff Harrod making the stop for Ole Miss. This game appears to be, at this point, as you look at Rocky Felker, appears to be tailor-made for Ole Miss. They're good against the run. They run the ball well.
Yeah, I don't think that this kind of weather really helps Mississippi State much because of the explosiveness of Don Smith. Anything that you could do to dampen his fuse is going to help you. And obviously, this rain's working against them.
Jonathan Shelley, number 39, and there's the nickelback now for Ole Miss. Second down, 7 from the 26 for the Bulldogs. Smith may throw the first pass of the day. He does. It is complete for the first down to number 21, Rodney Peters. And out of bounds at the 35-yard line. So Don Smith gets another first down by tossing to his running back, Rodney Peters.
One of the things Ole Miss has to be concerned about is you look at Vince Hoke there in the white jacket. The defensive coordinator at Temple for 13 years. He's here working this Mississippi State defense. One of the things they have to be concerned about at Mississippi is containing Don Smith. Get somebody upfield faster.
Hand off Peters. Works his way near the 40, about 4 or 5 yards. He was tripped up and brought down at the 34. It was Rodney Lowe, number 31. Now, Don Smith has just moved past Wayne Peace and is now chasing only John Reeves, the most total offense in the history of the Southeastern Conference.
And Don Smith has done it the hard way. John Reeves, obviously one of the greatest quarterbacks ever to play in the SEC. Most of his yardage was accumulated through the year.
Second down, 6 from the 40. Big opening for Robinson. First down, Calvin Robinson, number 33, gets it to the 48-yard line. And now the Bulldogs with a little bit of breathing room for the first time.
Ole Miss is going to be more concerned about Don Smith keeping the ball than they will be concerned about the fullback carrying it. As a result, the fullback may have a little extra daylight this afternoon.
Well, we're going to see four of them, Robinson, Taylor, Patton, McKelpin, although McKelpin walked off limping a little while ago. First down, 10, Bulldogs. They're at about the 48-yard line. Hand off inside again. Inside Ole Miss territory. Gain of about 4 that time for Calvin Robinson again. Off the right guard position. Ole Miss leads 7-0, 2:12 to go first quarter.
Another thing I'm sure is on Don Smith's mind, I don't think he's real anxious to pitch the ball in this kind of weather. This kind of weather will obviously double the chance that the running back can't hang onto the football or it might slip through his grasp, or he won't get a good pitch on the ball. So it's going to be pretty much fullback and quarterback.
Second down, 6 from the 49 of Ole Miss. First penetration of Rebel territory by the Bulldogs. Smith wants to keep, does. Now pitches. Oh, that was close, but close enough for some success. And it's going to be about, looks to me, about a yard short of the first down. Jeff Patton finally got the football.
We talked about Mike Fitzsimmons, number 1. 71, excuse me, penetrates upfield. Normally, we'll make that tackle, but probably because of the pain in his left shoulder, wasn't able to maintain his grasp, his hold on Don Smith, and Don Smith, as a result, eluded him, pitched the ball. Nice gain for Mississippi State.
Third and a long one inside the 45-yard line. Full house backfield for the Bulldogs. Big third down conversion opportunity here. And Peters stumbled before he got the ball, but I think he may have got the first down. I'm looking at the mark of the official there on his left foot. Sometimes it makes a lot of difference as to whether he marks it with his left or right foot. It's going to be first down, Bulldogs, I believe. Harrod with the tackle. Watch 21 stumble here as he comes starts.
It's a little trouble. You see, he loses his footing with his left foot and regains good athletic ability, regains his balance, and he happens to get there just in time. Tom Goode, Stam Sims doing a nice job of creating a crack for him.
So Rodney Peters picks up the first down on the run. This time he got it on the pass previously. First and 10 at the 42 of Ole Miss now. Here comes Peters again. Only a couple this time to the 40. Tackled by 31, Rodney Lowe.
Tom Goode playing center. His dad is really a legend in the NFL. Not as many people know about his story as should know about it. I mean, he was the most valuable player for the Miami Dolphins in the late 60s as a center. Ended his career in 1970 with the Dolphins, figured he wouldn't play anymore, had several operations to clean his body up, came back at the end of the year, and he was the guy that snapped the ball on the Jim O'Brien field goal for the Baltimore Colts in the Super Bowl. We'll get back and talk about that.
Second down eight, Don Smith keeping, has an opening. Drives inside the 35 to the 34. Jeff Noblin with a stop. Clock down to 23 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Is time winding down. A reminder for those stations down the line, we will be running commercial spot number 6 as the first spot in the second quarter. Maybe. No, maybe. We'll definitely be doing that. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, and that's going to be the end of the first quarter. Play with Ole Miss leading by a score of 77 to nothing on a 73-yard touchdown drive. And the Bulldogs are threatening. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT. Today's game is being brought to you by Bud Light, the light beer with a first name and taste. Everything else is just a light. It'll be third down two here as we open the second quarter. Ole Miss leading by a score of 7-0. The ball at the 34-yard line of the Rebels. Three tight ends in the ball game for the Bulldogs on the short yardage situation with Rodney Peters and Calvin Robinson in the backfield. Handoff goes to Peters. He bobbled the ball. It belongs to Ole Miss at the 35-yard line. Ole Miss Jeff Harrod falls on the ball. He is the man of the hour.
Watch Mike Fitzsimmons here, number 71. Gets a great jump on the ball, penetrates, messes up the timing of the play, and then Howard Moss is right there to stick Rodney Peters. The ball pops loose. Big play by Mississippi.
Look at 71 here.
Almost offsides.
It was held, I think.
Ball pops loose. Ole Miss football.
First down 10 from the 35. Mark Young's going to throw his first pass of the day. It is complete. No, incomplete. The ball came loose. Incomplete. Intended for Ricky Myers. He was hit hard by Kirby Jackson. Let's go to our studios in Atlanta and Kevin Slater.
All right, Bob. Pitt had gone out in front of Penn State 7-3, but on the ensuing kickoff, look at the move by Blair Thomas as he gets around the corner. Heads north, 91 yards later, he's got a touchdown on the kickoff return, and Penn State goes back into the lead, 10-7, now in the second quarter. Great game there. Let's go back to Jackson.
Kevin, we'll keep you posted on the Penn State-Pittsburgh game, as well as Ole Miss-Mississippi State here at Memorial Stadium, second down 10. Penalty markers down. Out to the 43-yard line goes Sean Sykes. On the play. Needed to get to the 45 for the first down.
Probably have a holding penalty in there.
This is the day of all the intersectional rivalries, or many of them anyway. And it looks like Sean Sykes is still down on the field injured. He may have been injured on that play. Sean Sykes had been injured early in the year, came off the injury, and thus far today, Sean Sykes has been running the ball very successfully, has over 70 yards. But he's down on the field momentarily. We're going to take this time out with 14:40 to go in the second quarter. So Sean Sykes, who had come off an injury, gets injured again here, Tim.
He breaks the tackle of Anthony Butts. Of course, has a hold of him. Looks like he got bent back over that left knee.
Willie Goodlow in there in place of him on second down and 20 now. Mark Young sprinting up, open for the toss. It is complete for the first down to Ricky Myers. And Myers out of bounds at the 42-yard line. The senior from Bassfield, Mississippi, his brother Jerry, is a player for the Mississippi State Bulldogs. Their parents are sitting down here in the Ole Miss cheering section. But Mark Young completes a 33-yarder.
This is that little set roll. Mississippi State defensive end comes inside, which enables Young to break outside the pocket to his left, square away his shoulders, and find Myers, who worked his way all the way back across the field.
Ole Miss to the 42-yard line, leading in the game 7-0. Ambrose in motion. Handoff Goodlow. Stood up after he got a couple right at the 40-yard line by 54 Gary Frank. I want to tell you, when you're stood up by Frank, 295 pounds, Goodloe only weighs 165.
Yeah, right. And, you know, Willie Goodloe is about the size of a shot put to Gary Frank, you know. And
I saw a wasp up here earlier bigger than Willie.
And Frank has come a long way since we saw him against Tennessee. Developing some instincts in that defensive interior line has made a lot of progress.
From the 40, second down seven. Ambrose in motion. Toss out to Ambrose. Has a block. Got outside. Ambrose is gone. Touchdown.
Number 6, A.R. Ambrose.
39-yard touchdown pass.
So you gamble and lose. You see Brian Hudson, number 18, right at the top of your screen, coming inside. Almost a great play by a Mississippi State defender, Leggett, but the pass is complete. He gets one block and then it's a wet day, but JR is smoking the grass.
Yeah, it's dry on the side over there where he just finished that run. Brian Owen for the point after. It's good, and this game is 14 to nothing. The Rebels of Ole Miss. And now we're going to take a commercial break. This is commercial spot number 8 with 13:34 to go, second quarter. It's 14 to nothing, Ole Miss, and if you're a Mississippi State fan, you might be wondering if they can score a touchdown, because Mississippi State has not scored a touchdown since the fourth quarter of the Auburn game, which Mississippi State lost 35-6. Bill Smith, number 10, set to kick off for Ole Miss. Michael Robinson, number 36, standing on the goal line. This will be his third kickoff return of this afternoon. Bill Smith is going to bring it down a little bit short for him, about the 70-yard line. Robinson. Oh, my, at the 20-yard line.
Tony
Michael
Bennett.
Robinson really was nailed. 89 is Tony Bennett. What a hit by Tony Bennett. He's really coming along. Georgia Tech just by 7 over Wake Forest. You'll see Georgia Tech playing at the University of Georgia next week at 12:30 Eastern time. We'll be there to bring that telecast to you.
They say, boom, boy, get your head up, Tony. They say he's built like Fred Dean. Barrel-chested, 230 pounds, good legs, just passing.
Ball pop loose down there. Let's see who has it. It remains in the possession of Mississippi State. Lopez Jones made the stop of 33 Calvin Robinson. Mississippi State bobbled the ball earlier. There's the drive. 65 yards, 40 of it coming on the little short toss. It was 39 and a half yards of run.
Yeah, and obviously that's a play that they saw last week, a play that Tennessee has made a living on for the last 3 years.
Second down seven, Bulldogs from their own 23-yard line. Don Smith. Got about 2 or 3 yards and not much more. Don Smith, who had been averaging 222 yards of total offense, has 8 yards passing and now has 22 yards running for a total offense today of 30. He needs 277 to become the all-time SEC leading leader in total offense.
Well, the officials missed one there. I don't know if, is that a jersey or a face mask? It was in the...
Tough to call.
Originally, I thought it was a face mask from up here, but just looking at it, it looked like it might have been a jersey instead of a face mask.
Third down four, and a long four for the Bulldogs. Receivers split wide left and right. I think we're going to have a timeout down there, and it'll be charged to Mississippi State with 12:09 to go. In the second quarter, the Rebels leading by a score of 14 to nothing. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT.
You're on the 10 o'clock American flight?
The meeting's this afternoon.
Seems like you're busier than ever.
Dad, I'm glad you could stop by.
Wish I had more time. Now, when did you say you were planning on coming home again?
Not until the end of the term.
You know, I don't think I can wait that long.
When you're something special, people know it.
So the issue is clear. Sony Video 8, the system of the future, or VHS-C, the compromise of the past. Now, as we've seen, the new Sony Handycam with autofocus and zoom gives you a measurably better picture, far superior sound, twice the recording time, and on Sony video cassettes, your memories are safe.
While on VHSC, they could be fleeting.
I rest my case.
The Sony Video 8 system. Judge for yourself.
Today's game is being brought to you by Delta Airlines, serving more than 100 cities in the U.S. and overseas. Delta gets you there with care.
Number 35, Jeff Noblin, the senior from Jackson, a scholar athlete, one of 11 in the entire nation. We talked to him about his academic achievements.
Well, I really didn't hear about it until a couple of weeks ago, but it's probably one of the most exciting things I've had since I've been here at school. You know, being one of 11 means a lot to me, and I've worked hard for it. And just the chance to get to meet other people around the country that have got the same award and go to New York is something that will never be taken away from me.
Jeff Noblin will be one of 11 young men honored at the Hall of Fame, Football Hall of Fame banquet in New York on December 10th, I believe it is, 9th or 10th. Tim Foley now will be up there. On third and four, it's complete for the first down on the far side and out of bounds at the 32-yard line. There's the rest, by the way, of the honor roll for the SEC, the all-academic team. You have to have a B average or better. Lewis Clark with the reception, by the way. Ole Miss has 5, Mississippi State 5. You see the leaders, the names we're mentioning there are the leaders with grade point average. Some of them, of course, are pre-med grade point averages, and some are fields of maybe not quite as much academic difficulty. Here's Peters. Second effort for the first down to the 43. Butch Davenport, Stephon Moore makes the stop. There's Sykes. He injured his left knee, went out early.
Don Smith, excellent job of ball handling here under these conditions. He lost me on it. Got rid of it just in time. Rodney Peters heading upfield. Looked like they had him stopped. Look at this fight. And this is the thing that I think is impressive about Mississippi State. Although they've had problems in recent games, they're still fighting. They're still struggling. This is a big game for him.
First down, 10, Smith throwing. Incomplete. Had his man open. It was number 82, Clark, again out there inside Ole Miss territory, but he just missed him with that toss.
As a defensive back in weather like this, Bob, what you have to do is give yourself a little bit more room. You know, you're looking at an old Mississippi defensive back there, Billy Brewer. But you want to give yourself a little bit more depth so you don't have to back out immediately, because if you back out immediately and try to plant to come forward, most likely you're going to slip.
Second down, 10 from the 43. Bulldogs trailing 14-0. Midway through the second period. Smith, plenty of time to throw. Almost picked off. It was knocked away at the last moment. The pass was intended for 84, John Lowe. Howard Moss, 38, was the guy that got his hand on it, I believe. If he did, in fact, get a hand on it. Oh, it's cold. This is a raw-boned weather day. Temperature in the middle 40s, and the rain continues to fall.
Lewis Clark, that on that last play, Bob, as the Smith tried to go to the outside, Lewis Clark was taking it down the middle, had an opportunity to go over the top.
Third down, 10. Bulldogs remain at the 43-yard line. 5 men rushing the passer. Don Smith gets it way long, has his man there. It was 25 Myers. The ball just didn't connect. He had beaten him deep.
Arthur Scott got to Don Smith just in time. Mississippi, third and long situations, has a tendency to blitz. Mississippi State tried to hurt him. Ball just barely overthrown.
That ball had just a little bit more air underneath it. Could have floated a little bit. I believe Myers could have run under it. Good low at Myers. Are back, and the other Myers, Ricky Myers, makes the reception. I said Myers, let me correct myself. Number 25 is Fred Hadley. I think you'll understand this when I tell you something. Fred Hadley's number 25. He's the Mississippi State player who didn't catch up the pass. Number 25 on the other side is Ricky Myers, and Jerry Myers, who's number 10, plays for Ole Miss. You've got all of that clear. Where we'll be next week.
Talk about emotion. the black and gold against the red of Georgia.
First down, 10 from the 22. This is Goodlow to the 33-yard line, close to the first down. Bulldogs having a great deal of difficulty stopping the run of Ole Miss.
This has been the problem for Bobby Wallace's defense most of the year. They put themselves in good situations. They find an opening. They're in position to make the play, and they try to rock them without grabbing. As a defensive player, you want to, if you're going to strike at them hard, just grab something. And that time, Sangster missed and Hudson missed. And Willie Goodloe's just not big enough to break those kind of tackles. Just grab them and throw them on the ground.
From the 33-yard line, Ole Miss, first down. Not much this time for 41 Joe Mickles. Yard or two, he was hit by Cedric Corse, the junior from Atlanta, 53. For the Bulldogs, the leading tackler for Mississippi State.
Last game for a couple of great cornerbacks for the Bulldogs. Bruce Plummer, playing right corner. Kirby Jackson on the left. Both excellent man-to-man coverage fellas that played for a defense over this 4 years that has blitzed a lot. They've been in man-to-man situations more than any two cornerbacks in the SEC.
Second down, 8 from the 35. Mark Young rolling and throwing. Incomplete. It was intended for the other 25, Ricky Myers. Hudson covering.
On that play, Bob, they were looking for J.R. Ambrose. They tried to bait Kirby Jackson to get him to jump on Ricky Myers on that little outside pattern. They ran J.R. Ambrose from his slot position down in behind him. But Kirby Jackson, knowledgeable veteran back there, didn't bite on the bait, and they ended up throwing the ball out of bounds.
You see the yardage domination by Ole Miss here. Ole Miss has thrown for 73, run for 114. Mississippi State's only thrown for 13. Third and 8. Another running play. Goodlow. Close to the 40 and bent back over his knees. Hope he's okay. It was a difficult situation for Goodlow down there. He was just folded over like a pretzel. He's all right. And it's a punting situation. Short of the first down, Bill Smith comes in. Bill Smith, an All-American punter last year, has frankly been in a slump this season, is third ranked in the SEC in punting as we go into this game.
Little Willie Goodlow taking on Cedric Corse, grab his feet, bend them back. Painful to be a runner in this league.
First punt of the day for Bill Smith, and Robinson just falls on it at the 16-yard line. And we'll be right back to Memorial Stadium in Jackson, Mississippi. The rain continues to fall at Memorial Stadium in Jackson. 9:18 to go, second quarter. Ole Miss leading by a score of 14-0. But the Rebel and Bulldog faithful remain here in large numbers. I'm very surprised with this game being televised in across the state of Mississippi. And the weather is cold and dreary as it is. They've still turned out for the Egg Bowl battle between the Rebels and the Bulldogs. First down, 10 from the 16. Don Smith trying a sweep. Not much, if any. Maybe half a yard. Boston College out in front of Holy Cross now in the second quarter. Georgia Tech still leading Wake Forest by a touchdown. Wisconsin in front of Michigan State in the second quarter. Disappointing year for the Spartans. They expected to do better. Missouri leading Kansas. And an 8-7 Clemson lead over South Carolina. First quarter score.
As you watch plays develop here, watch the middle linebackers, two middle linebackers for Ole Miss, Bob. They're going to shadow Don Smith.
Smith throwing. Incomplete. Intended for Heath Jackson, the freshman tight end. But he was smacked hard at the 27.
Thunder Smith again. See, they're going to be concerned about contain on Don Smith. They'll try to fight somebody upfield on defense. You see Walls working upfield. Try to get to Smith in a hurry. Now, one of the linebackers will force, the other one will drag across, as Robert Smith does there, to try to pick up anything, any throwback. And he did a very effective job on that play.
He stepped in here and played very well at the position that was vacated by the injury to Fuzzy Huddleston. Was Huddleston and Rod two excellent linebackers till Huddleston was injured during the Georgia game. On third down and 10, Don Smith just slings it loose. There's a penalty. It's going to be intentional grounding of the ball. Smith in the grasp of Rodney Lowe. So if in fact that is what the penalty is, there's the signal. It will be loss of down.
Once again, Bob, Mississippi State trying to go up over the top. Good choice. They couldn't get anybody open. They were looking for a back coming out of the backfield up the left sideline. But Joe Nathan Shelley was back there as the fifth defensive back. It's good to see him back playing again. Cornerback, star cornerback for this Ole Miss defense who had been injured against Georgia. Now he's back on the field. Just a good job of coverage by the Rebels.
A spot of the foul penalty, meaning that they penalized from the spot of where the violation occurred. It's half the distance. And now you can see the punt comes out of the end zone. That's a pretty good one. Ricky Myers at the 46. To the 41-yard line goes Ricky Myers, and there Ole Miss will have control of the ball, an excellent field position, leading 14 to nothing with 8:45 to go second quarter. At halftime, the Ole Miss Pride of the South band, they'll be wet, but they'll be entertaining. Mississippi State Maroon band here also, of course. We'll have all the updates on the other rivalries going on today in college football, particularly the Michigan-Ohio State game.
Fourteen to three at that one at last look, right? Ohio State.
Yes. Young bobbles the ball as he wanted to pitch it on a reverse and falls on it back there at the 45. That play just couldn't get underway, primarily due to the very slippery conditions. As you're probably able to see, the mud kicking up on the players down there. The center of this field is pretty muddy. The grass has been worn away. High schools play here, in addition to Mississippi State some and Ole Miss some, and this is a well-used stadium. And lightning just flashed across the horizon.
Brought oohs and ahs from the crowd.
One of the most exciting plays of the day.
I'm not sure I'd like to be playing in the band.
Second down at 14 from the 45-yard line. Nichols to the 38. Number 41, Mickles, was tackled by 45, Willie Monroe from Starkville.
They tried to come with a reverse on first down. Tried to gimmick him a little bit on first down, trying to get Mississippi State pursuing into the sidelines. But Earl Leggett, there goes my Chicago background, right? Played for the Bears in 55. Jerry Leggett stayed at home, did a good job. Even if they'd gotten the toss, it would have been any good.
No relation there. Third down, 7 from the 39. It is complete to Willie Green, who went out of bounds at the 24, first down. Willie Green, the true freshman from Athens, Georgia.
You're going to see this again. Green clears Bruce Plummer on the short side of the field. Bruce got to get a little bit of depth. Give Brian Hudson some time to get over there. Nice stick.
You see, he got his foot out of bounds. He stepped on the inline as soon as he caught it, but he caught it with 1 foot in, then stepped out, and that's where they marked the ball at the 24-yard line. First down, 10, Ole Miss. 7:35 to go in the first half. Rebels lead 14 to nothing. Good low. Not much that time. Monroe, 45, with the stop again. The linebacker from the outside. He and Leggett swap in and out of there, that position.
Willie Goodloe. Been a big surprise, I think, for Ole Miss. They were really discouraged when Sean Sykes went down early in the year, but Goodloe came in and with enthusiasm and bounce, and you've seen him run today. He runs with excitement, hard to knock off his feet.
This has been Ole Miss's quarter all year long, the second. It is second down, 8. Good low to about the 18, short of the first down. Ole Miss did score one touchdown this quarter, of course. Ambrose on the 40-yard touchdown reception. The other touchdown came on a good low 3-yard run after a 73-yard drive. When it was 7-0 came in the first quarter. Those were the only two scores of the game thus far. Be third down and 4 from the 18.5-yard line. Ricky Myers wide to the right side. Willie Green splits to the left. Inside handoff, only a couple of yards once again. It was Joe Mickles, the fullback, carrying the ball. He is short of the first down. And Ole Miss on the third and four elected to remain conservative. They are in field goal range at the 12, and I think Mark Young wants to come to the sideline to discuss it with Billy Brewer and the Brain Trust. 14 to nothing lead. On fourth and a long two, do they go for the field goal or to convert the fourth down? Well, give me a moment to remind you that this telecast is authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the Southeastern Conference and is intended solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, rebroadcast, or retransmission of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game in whole or in part without the express written consent of the Southeastern Conference and the Turner Broadcasting System is prohibited. It's like the lightning is hitting as a thunderstorm is a few miles from here, but right over the stadium. The rain just comes drizzling down at the moment. It's not pouring as hard now as it was a few minutes ago. They are going to go for the field goal attempt, as you see number 8 Brian Owen out there from the 24. It'll be a 34-yard attempt.
And one of the things you worry about here is your kicker's ability to maintain his footing. As he drives into the ball, plants that left foot, often you see kickers in this kind of footing just skid out. It happened to Reves in the last play of the game against Georgia Tech. Tennessee missed a field goal.
Brian Owen got his foot into that one very well. It's good. A 34-yard field goal by the young sophomore from Nashville, Tennessee, Brian Owen. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT. I truly enjoy the Tim Foley analysis of field goal kicking. Tim, what about this one?
I think the most difficult job here the holder has, especially on a day like today. It's a nice job of getting the ball down. Now, watch his left foot. He plants it, takes extra care, really turns his ankle, concerned about sliding through it, and boing.
And one of those, big football players knocked him down, too. Bryant's only 5'6", weighs about 155, they say. My guess is that's with equipment on. He's small, excellent field kicker, too. He's only a sophomore. He's going to be really good in a couple of years. From the 12, it is Lydell Curry. Penalty marker down, and Curry goes down out to the 37-yard line. 25-yard return, may have been a late hit. If so, that'll move the Bulldogs out to pretty good field position. There's Rom Gilbert in the white hat, our referee today.
Well, Rom saw Rom in Orlando a few weeks ago. Mississippi State needs to make something happen. Who is that? Bill Smith coming in?
That's the punter.
Personal foul. Curry.
And they move it all the way to the 48-yard line. You're not going to see a punter get called for that kind of play very often. Bill Smith is a physical specimen. I mean, the guy's 6'4", 220 pounds, the punter. But still not a very intelligent play by young Mr. Smith. First down, 10. Bulldogs, a couple of yards, not much more than 45, goes Calvin Robinson, number 33. 5.5 minutes remaining in the second quarter. It is 17 to nothing, Ole Miss leading Mississippi State. In case you're tuning in late, you'll see what's happened in this ball game. Ole Miss got on the board after an excellent 73-yard drive, and Sean Sykes really got him down there running, but Goodloe took it in. And Ole Miss on a 40-yard TD reception from Mark Young to Ambrose, and then the field goal moments ago. Don Smith has some running room this time. Gets the first down inside the 35 to the 33-yard line. Don Price, 45, with the tackle. And now in 7 carries, Don Smith has 35 yards. He has 13 yards passing.
And whenever Mississippi State sees Ole Miss in a situation where they don't have a man on the line of scrimmage, they'll try to get to that rollout. That time, Fitzsimmons was the man that had the responsibility of containing that play. Walls is dropping off. Don Smith will take advantage of that situation every time.
30, Jeff Patton, the fullback, under the play last time, limped off the field. We'll check his condition. It's first down, 10 now from the 33 Bulldogs. Good block. Don Smith near the 25-yard line before he goes down. Jeff Bacon gets the stop for Ole Miss. Penalty marker down. I think it's going to go against Ole Miss. Personal foul, Rebels. This series, this is the 83rd meeting between the two teams, was marred by incredible violence between the players and the fans back in the early 1900s. They finally got that settled down, but you're still going to see a lot of personal foul type plays in this game. The emotions run a little higher than coaches would like for them to. All the way to the 13.
Personal foul. Defense. First down.
The Bulldogs, with two personal foul aided penalties, have moved this ball down inside the 15. Their closest connection to the goal line yet. There, as we chart Don Smith, you see he's 222 yards away of total offense in this game. Inside handoff to 33, Robinson. Gets to the 10, to the 9-yard line.
Robinson might have been able to take it in if he didn't maintain his footing right there. He found the crack. Robinson had gotten an excellent block for Don Smith on the play before this. Now they hand him the football. Harrod kind of taken out of the picture, but he's tripped up as he moves in toward the goal line.
They move it back to the 10. They previously spotted it at the 9. Second down, 7. Have to get inside the 3 for the first down. Don Smith. Down to the 1. First down, Bulldogs. Arthur Scott with a tackle, so it'll be first and goal at the 1 on the run by Don Smith. I don't believe he was injured. I think he was pulling mud off of his face.
Containment has got to be primary. Good block on Fitzsimmons. No containment here. Smith decides, I don't need to throw it. Here I come. And he probably accelerates as fast as anyone that I've ever seen, from nothing to full speed.
Unless the Bulldogs win this game, in which case they could go to the Independence Bowl, this could be the last collegiate football game for Don Smith. He has been looked at very carefully by professional football scouts. They like him as a possible running back. They like him as you see the mud there. That's what we were showing you earlier when he went down. The mud just got inside the helmet, so they're cleaning that off. Potential defensive back. And right. A lot of people think that Don Smith at 6'1", 195 will be a pro football player.
And some folks want to know, well, why not a quarterback? He's got a good arm. He's got good ability. And when you get to the professional level, you have to do what you do best. And I would say this, Don Smith's feet are better than his arm. He separates himself from the crowd with his quickness, ability, and his aggressiveness, because he doesn't have the mentality of most quarterbacks. I tell you what, when you intercept a pass that he threw, you better watch out, because he's upset and he's going to come get you.
And he can catch you. See if we see the end of this, where he got all the mud in the helmet as Don Smith goes down hard there. There it goes. Oh, just like a steam shovel there.
Ole Miss with 5 defensive backs. You saw Joe Nathan Shelley in there.
3 tight ends. First down goal from just outside the 1. Rebels lead 17-0. 3:35 to go, second quarter. The Bulldogs knocking at the door. Whoops. Number 66, Stan Sims. Looks like it'll go against the Bulldogs, and if so, that'll take them away from the door and move it out to the 6. Just what the Bulldogs didn't need, but that's what's happened to them often all year. And that makes it tough, but it's still first and goal at the 6.
And a couple of coaches' hats.
Ball start, interior lineman moved, offense.
A couple of coaches' hats hit the deck over the Mississippi State side. They just, you know, frustration. Harrod trying to draw the offensive player offside. That defensive player can come into that zone and get back. He can do that. But an offensive player, once he's got his hand down and set, cannot move.
Different offensive set now. First and goal for the 6. They split out a little wider. Still give to Peters. He drives to about the 3 and then is pushed back. Jeff Harrod again. Harrod at 6'1", 240 pounds. Is a significant football player for Ole Miss defensively.
Great story, too. Really not recruited by anyone. Grew up in Birmingham, and it was between...
That's him, 66 there.
Yeah, it was between Ole Miss and the Marine Corps. He made the logical choice, I think, and he's played like a Marine. Of course, Ron Case, the defensive backfield coach here at Ole Miss, is a Marine, and so he loves it.
So he got Ole Miss and the Marine Corps.
That's right.
Second down goal, the 3.5. Don Smith wants to keep it. Doesn't get it. 2 of the 3, maybe. Arthur Scott will receive credit for the tackle, number 95 for Ole Miss. And it's going to be third down goal from about the three. And oh my, how large a play it was when Stan Sims jumped the gun.
And you talk about not scoring. Rocky Felker has been coaching from behind for the last three games. And obviously, you do things that are not necessarily prudent. In the normal situation, fourth and third and three. Well, this is third and three. Hang on a second, Foley.
Okay, just hold that. If they don't get in, you can make the point. If so, it wouldn't have mattered, right? Don Smith, batted down by Noblin. It was intended for Lewis Clark. And now your point can be made, because now it is a fourth down situation.
Noblin made the same kind of play last week against Tennessee. They try to get Lewis Clark, their best athlete, best receiver, working one-on-one on Noblin. Smith tries to just dump him the ball. If we'd have lofted it up in the air, might have had a chance.
Artie Cosby, number two, comes in to attempt the field goal. They will spot the ball right at the 10. So it's a 20-yard field goal attempt, a very harsh angle. 2:11 to go in the second quarter. Kick is good, and the Bulldogs are on the scoreboard, but they still have not scored a touchdown since the fourth quarter of the Auburn game back in mid-October. That's frustrating. Rocky Felker, himself a total offense kind of quarterback when he was all-conference at Mississippi State, but now it's 17-3, the Rebels leading, with 2:06 remaining in the second quarter.
And Rocky's talking to the official about pass interference. He felt like Noblin interfered on that particular play. From a coach's standpoint, you're looking at the initial first few steps. Once your receiver, the receiver lined up inside, gets inside the defender, that's 6 points in your mind. You feel like he's got it made. And that time, Noblin made a nice play coming back inside.
And the Ole Miss defense denies the touchdown again. They have been really good inside their 10-yard line, denying some of the great teams in the country scoring touchdowns on the ground. They certainly did it there to Mississippi State, but you had to think the Bulldogs would probably have got it in at first down and goal from the one, minus the 5-yard penalty.
Ole Miss has been tough down in there. They had a big goal line stand against LSU a couple of weeks ago. They had really first and goal from inside the one and didn't get it in.
Here is an unusual situation as they line up wanting to onside it possibly, and he decides instead to scribble the kick. It almost stops in the muck down there. It is picked up by Reed Hines out to the 35. That was one of the more unusual kickoff alignments I've seen in my day, Tim Foley. You had some duty with special teams.
Boy, I used to hate that. You know, the one team that you really hated being on, and I shouldn't really admit this, it was the onside kick return team, because you only get called on in pressure situations. At the end of the game, they're going to try an onside kick, and so here you go. You got to go in there and try to be a third baseman.
First down 10 from the 35. Young. It's a good low. Nice move. Out near the 40 goes Willie Goodlow. Clock ticking down inside 2 minutes now in the second quarter. Penalty marker is on the field over here on the near sideline. It's going to go against Ole Miss. Holding. Rebels.
Might have been on Anthony Butts. Anthony Butts is getting in a situation where you really can't see his number any longer.
Young lady warming up here before performing at halftime. Warming up literally. Temperature in the middle 40s here. It's been raining. The rain is lessening a bit now, though, from the beginning of the ball game.
Holding!
One thing you've got to be concerned about in a game like this, there's so much emotion, it doesn't dissipate with a 17-0 lead. You can't let Mississippi State up off the mat. You have to stay on top of them.
It is first down 20, Ole Miss now. They spot the ball just outside the Ole Miss 25-yard line. 17-0, Rebels leading the Bulldogs in the Egg Bowl, as they call it here in Jackson, Mississippi. The 83rd meeting between these two teams. The Egg Bowl is actually an egg-shaped football trophy that originated in 1927. And they're taking some extra time to get that ball dry. Everything's set. We're ready to go. Mark Young, 3 out of 5 for 93 yards passing. Neither team able to pass very well so far today in this muddy condition. Goodlow down hard. Willie Monroe was back there to meet him at the 24. With the conservative bent of Billy Brewer, who, as he told us last week, he really plays his offense to his defensive team. In other words, to complement his great defensive team, he tries to maintain ball control, keep it on the ground, and not do anything really crazy offensively. And you bet now, with a minute remaining in this quarter, inside the 25, they'll be conservative.
Exactly. He likes to counterpunch with his offense. Lets his defense make a big play, and then the offense takes advantage of it.
Good low inside handoff to the 28. Clock continuing to tick, 49, 48, and counting. Down on the lower left-hand side, and Mississippi State, because we are going to have a third down in long yardage, calls timeout. They will be out of timeouts now. But it could give them an opportunity to have a little bit of offense remaining. Tim, we look at the weather here. I always get your Air Foley as Tim flies in his private plane often. The weather forecast here, what do you think about the conditions here today?
2,500 overcast. Winds out of the southeast, about 12 knots.
You flew in yesterday. Matter of fact, you literally almost flew right into the stadium. There is Air Foley, folks.
There's Air Foley. We've talked about it.
Those were light stanchions that you saw there right in front. Tim was pretty low as he came over the stadium. This is how Tim scouts the practices. Sky King, Sky Foley.
Right. My little boy with me.
Make flying look like fun there.
Hey, yeah.
What kind of airplane is that? That's a Cessna?
It's a Piper Lance.
A Piper Lance. See, I'm weak on my aircraft identification.
We got to get you up in there, Roberto.
Well, maybe today.
Yeah, but really.
With the weather and really. the strong winds, perfect for me to get up there.
If it goes 85 and sunny, right?
47 seconds to go, second quarter. It is third down, 17, Ole Miss. They're going to keep it on the ground. Goodlow goes down at the 28. So the clock will continue to run. Because Mississippi State's out of timeouts, they will have their opportunity to have the ball. Goodlow a little slow getting up, but I think he's okay. They'll have the opportunity to have the ball because, of course, they've got to get this playoff in 25 seconds. But probably only one opportunity. Michael Robinson will go back to take the Bill Smith punt.
Smith is a power punter, nails the ball long often, but does take a significant amount of time getting the ball away.
I just noticed something. The play clock has more time on it than the quarter clock, meaning that they will not have to get this play off. The play clock did not start when the game clock started because the players, they don't start that clock until the official signals the ball ready for play. They waited longer than normal, thereby the time expired in the quarter, and Mississippi State did not have an opportunity with the ball. At halftime, it's Ole Miss 17, Bulldogs 3.
We're not a company.
But no company has more pride in what they do.
Or more pride in how well they do it.
We offer you a meaningful and fulfilling future.
One that goes far beyond the ordinary.
One that brings with it the respect and admiration of Americans everywhere.
We're not a company.
We're your country.
We're the Air Force.
The Marines.
The Army.
The Navy.
We're the Armed Forces.
It's a great place to start.
This baby will blow the doors off anything on the road, just like a BMW.
Isn't she a beauty? BMW would build one like this.
You think BMW has advanced technology? Listen to this.
Your door is open.
Huh?
For about $22,000, you can own a BMW 325. Or the hollow feeling of having settled for less.
Well, an unusual situation has developed here. As I told you, there was more time left on the play clock than the game clock. So the team's left. They've called them back out. And even though that clock hadn't ticked down, they've charged a 5-yard delay of game penalty to Ole Miss, brought the teams back out, and are going to force them to punt the ball with no time left on the clock, but an opportunity for Mississippi State to get their hands on the ball here.
Well, what ought to happen is he ought to just run with the field. Well, he's going to punt it. With no time left on the clock, I would assume the thing to do would be to catch the ball, go down. You're not taking any chance, no risk.
Exactly. But Robinson didn't handle the ball either. And all Bill Smith got was a 45-yard punt after time had expired. We've seen some craziness here today. We'll be right back. Some of the significant statistics there, you'll notice on the left-hand column under the Bulldogs, only 13 yards passing. There have been two Mississippi State turnovers. The first one came early in the ball game and led to a missed field goal attempt. The second one did result in a touchdown pass when Ole Miss got their hands on that second fumble, a 40-yard TD pass from Young to J.R. Ambrose. And the game is 17-3 in terms of time of possession. Otherwise pretty even. Also on the ground, 131 yards, 120 yards. So Ole Miss has changed jerseys here, and this happens relatively often with the Ole Miss Rebels. It is not necessarily anything significant, a wet, muddy game, and they simply went from their red jerseys to their blue.
You know, the half ended in some confusion. What they finally decided in talking to Gordon Pettis, the man that heads up the FCC officials, is that they started the on-the-field play clock 4 seconds too late. So that last play, there are actually 4 seconds left to go in the half, so Smith did have to punt the ball.
And the kickoff is out of bounds, and there's a potential penalty here. The flag is down, and they'll probably back it up 5 yards and kick it off from the 30-yard line. Bill Smith angled it over to the right side, trying to keep it away from Lewis Clark, who is the deep man. And they'll move it back to the 30, and these guys get to run down in the mud one more time. So it's getting colder, but the rain is definitely lessening here. There you see the total offensive leader. This is in the history of the Southeastern Conference. John Reeves of Florida leads Don Smith and Wayne Peace.
And it's unfortunate that Don Smith ran into a day like this in terms of the weather as a climax for a fabulous career with Mississippi State, the man that has carried the offensive fortunes for the Bulldogs for the last 4 years.
Look at that strong, incredibly strong leg on Bill Smith. Drives Clark back to the one. Down to the 19, and he's hit hard again. 89, Tony Bennett with another bone-jarring tackle on special teams, and the Bulldogs trailing 17-3 take over at their own 20-yard line. Don Smith with 51 yards on the ground, 13 passing for 64 yards of total offense today. And by the way, speaking of Don Smith, he has not thrown for or rushed for a touchdown since the Tulane game back on October 18th. That's 18 plus quarters. On the first down, see some new jerseys in there for Mississippi State too, some dry ones. Out to the 23 goes Rodney Peters.
Wesley Walls, Mike Fitzsimmons doing a fine job hemming up that trap. No hole able to develop there. Gain of 3 for Mississippi State.
Winner of this ball game will go to the Independence Bowl in Shreveport, Louisiana. Splitting wide to the left side is John Lowe. To the right side, Lewis Clark for the Bulldogs on second down 7 from the 23-yard line. Robinson and Peters in the backfield. Smith throwing. It's complete to Robinson at the 28-yard line. Needs to get to the 30 for the first down. Lopez Jones covering.
Mississippi's defense under the direction of Carl Torbush, who has been a Billy Brewer assistant for a number of years. They do an exceptional job of disguising their defensive alignment. They move just before the ball is snapped, not to give the quarterback much of a pre-read. They confuse a lot of offenses in the SEC.
On third down 3, Don Smith keeping, trying it upfield. First down a little bit more out to the 35-yard line. Jeff Noblin will trip him up, but it's a first down to the 35-yard line for Don Smith.
Let's check the blocking out here for Mississippi. You see Sims, number 66, pulling out. Walls fighting off the block of Heath Jackson. Calvin Robinson gets in the way. I wouldn't say that was a punishing block, but creates the space that Smith needs. In one more step, Smith is gone.
13:25 remaining third quarter. First down 10 from the 35. To the fullback, Robinson. Weaves his way to the 40. Robert Smith with the stop. Mississippi State has has put together some good rushing yardage today, but they have not been able to combine it with much through the air. Only 18 yards passing.
It's awfully hard to develop an offensive game plan when they found themselves behind so early in their previous three games. And so you can't stay with a consistent plan. You've got to start taking risks, put the ball up in the air deep.
Second down six from the 39. On the option again, Don Smith. Close to the first down, but they say he stepped out just about a foot shy at the 44-yard line. Now the rain's starting again, Tim. You'll be happy to hear. But I still haven't seen any more of the Wasps. Smith just had to get to the 45 there. You see that Noblin came over there to hurry him, forced him out to the 44-yard line.
Got the end of it here. Runs out of bounds, tries to pull up on that wet sideline, can't get himself stopped, has to hurdle the table there and comes down on the track.
Third and about a foot. Double tight ends. Matter of fact, three of them in there for the Bulldogs. Don Smith keeps it. Almost popped that thing open there. Got a 48-yard line first down Bulldogs. Jeff Arad with one of his many tackles today.
This is one of those games, Bob, that the longer it goes on, the colder you get. Usually you warm up during the
game. I was noticing that. Yeah. You're talking about us or the players?
Well, I'm talking about those guys down there. See, we're just cold. They're wet and cold.
Now we have John Lowe and Fred Hadley splitting wide to the left side on the first and 10 from the 47. This is a good place to pass the ball if the team feels like they want to do that. They don't. And in comes Mike Fitzsimmons to throw Don Smith down at the 43-yard line. A loss of nearly five on the play.
There's old Mike Fitzsimmons, Philadelphia, Texas Ranger.
There aren't many of them.
No, keeping the streets of Philadelphia clean, and that time putting Don Smith in the mud.
They're going to miss Mike Fitzsimmons.
They are going to miss his leadership ability. You know, he's one of those guys that when you look at him, he doesn't really look like he can play that well. He's not as tall as you'd like him to be, and maybe not as muscular in terms of stature, but wow, when you start the clock, he's a player.
Second down 14, Don Smith under pressure again. Batted out of the air by 88 Lopez Jones. But there was incredible pressure up the middle from Howard Moss. Actually from the outside, but the pressure came from way on the outside. It was either Howard Moss or Jonathan Shelley who had come in to pressure the quarterback. There it is, 39, Jonathan Shelley who's in the game. It was 88 Lopez Jones who batted it down.
When they get in that five defensive back set, Bob, as you know, Mississippi likes to come after you. And they'll come after you with Howard Moss from the outside.
Third down, 14 now, as the drive stalls after they nail Don Smith in the backfield, unless he can convert on this third down. Pressure. Robinson down hard at the 41. It was Jeff Noblin with a bone-jarring tackle, but hold it. There's a penalty marker in the backfield. Smith was hit after the pass by Lopez Jones, I think, 88. Personal foul. It's against Ole Miss. You can see Lopez Jones, 88, he knows what happened.
Lopez Jones coming here, Smith and Harad up the middle, and here comes Lopez Jones as the ball is released. Smith chasing, the ball is gone.
Looks like a wrestler.
Yeah.
You know, one of those.
Yeah, and it's, you know,
Russell faster.
He got to the lunchroom right before they locked the door, and he ran through the door. It's tough, man. You work all day to get in a position like that, and it's amazing how fast you can rationalize. Well, the ball hasn't really been gone that long.
And it's money, and if I hold my hands up, they'll know that I wasn't being malicious.
Right.
Nevertheless, it was a significant penalty as it moves the ball inside Ole Miss territory to 42. The rain now coming down in sheets at Memorial Stadium. Here's Peters. Nice opening. Inside the 35 to the 34-yard line goes Rodney Peters. Gain him about six or seven. Harad with the stop once again for the Ole Miss Rebels.
And one of Tom Goode's, the offensive line coach for the Bulldogs, one of his charges, got a nice block there. Carl Middleton filling in for Durwood Miner. The injured Durwood Miner pulled to his left and got a nice block.
It'll be second down three from the 45-yard line. Bulldogs, it's a long three. have to get near the 31 for the first down. Robinson Peters have remained the running backs. Play fake. Going for everything. That's Hadley, 25. Incomplete. Good coverage job down there by 27, Stevon Moore, the cornerback. And so it'll be third down and about three now for the Bulldogs. Stevon Moore, one of the better cornerbacks. He's only a sophomore, and already professional scouts are keeping their eye on him.
Right, and he was thrown into action last year early because of some injuries, and in his second start, he faced Mark Zeno of Tulane, and Zeno caught 12 passes on him, and that would shatter, that might disturb someone's confidence, but that didn't ruffle Stevon Moore, and he's one of the best man-to-man coverage people there are in the SEC.
Third down, long three. Don Smith gives to the running back. He may not have made it. I believe Calvin Robinson, 33, did not get the first down. Harrod was there to stop him again. Wait for the spot of the ball. They may have to bring, no, he is shy of the first down. It's going to be fourth and just inches. So the gamble on the touchdown pass results, I think, in a fourth down conversion attempt.
But I think it was a smart gamble, Bob, because Mississippi plays those intermediate routes so tough. I think Rocky feels his best chance is over the top because they have had some people open this afternoon. They just haven't gotten the ball.
Marcus Bush, 22, in the backfield now, along with Robinson. Fourth down, inches. Don Smith wanted a throw, broke loose from the tackle. Can he turn the corner? Knocked out of bounds, and I believe, yes, short of the first down. Good quarterback pressure came from Harrod. He was on Don Smith just as Don looked up. The ball goes over to the Rebels of Ole Miss with 9:40 to go, third quarter. The University of Mississippi leading Mississippi State 17-3. Some great pressure here from 66, Harrod.
See Harrod on the right side of your screen. Marcus Bush, the onside back, he's got to step up. He's got to step up, take Harrod on to give Smith some time to let that play develop.
Ole Miss ball. Here comes Goodlow. Driven out of bounds at the 39-yard line. The play started at about the 34, so give him a gain of five. Bruce Plummer with the play for Mississippi State. 9:34 to go, third quarter.
That's the type of play that you check off to, Bob, in a situation. You see those linebackers up there. The interesting thing, though, Stevon Moore was working against Lewis Clark to the wide side of the field. Moore had backed off a little bit. He wasn't in a position to be beaten with the fade like most defensive backs would have been in that situation.
Second down, five from the 39. Goodlow to the 41. You can bet Ole Miss is not going to be throwing the ball very often. Sangster with the tackle with their 17-3 lead. Georgia Tech having a problem with Wake Forest. It's at Wake Forest, leading by four. Michigan State now leading Wisconsin in the second quarter. Look at that one. An upset in the making? Maybe, but it's early. West Virginia leading Syracuse at the half. North Carolina and Duke all knotted up in the second quarter in ACC action. Here it's 17-3 Ole Miss on a third down three from the 41. The option toss. Not much to it. Out of bounds at the 44. It was J.R. Ambrose. A couple of significant scores here. Purdue with the last game for Coach Burnett leading Indiana 10-0 in the second quarter.
You know, that's like this game here, Bob. Purdue, Indiana. You know, it doesn't matter what has happened. Indiana obviously going to a bowl, and Purdue has had a very long year, but that doesn't make any difference when those two teams line up.
I'm not surprised at it. Here's one of the longest punts I've seen all year from Bill Smith. Line of scrimmage, by the way, for that was at the 44-yard line. The ball will be credited for 57, but it carried further than that. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT. Bob Neal and Tim Foley with you from Jackson, Mississippi, along with our excellent booth crew working under adverse circumstances today. Alex Vergara with the statistics and Kim Anderson in charge of player identification and foul weather gear. And Paula Edge dressed in her Natalie attired rubber rain suit. Don Smith on the first and 10, picking his way out to the 23-yard line. Gain of only a couple. Don Smith now up around 63 yards on the day rushing, but he's thrown for only 18. Tim, you would expect that Don Smith, because they're trailing 17-3, would have to go to the air here pretty soon and start trying to hit some of these receivers.
Well, I think they've tried to go to the air, Bob. Mississippi doing a nice job of coverage. They tried to throw it long down in the corner. They tried in a fourth and short situation, they tried to go up over the top, and it's just a matter of their receivers are having a hard time getting free in this footing.
Second down 8 from the 22. Don Smith keeping it again. Has some running room this time. He's got a lot of running room. He's outside. He'll be gone. Can they catch him? Yes, from behind. Who was it? Stevon Moore, probably. It must. Yes, it was 27. Stevon Moore. He's the only man with the speed to get him from behind. A 33-yard run for Don Smith, and that'll take him up nearly 100 yards rushing.
Watch the block by the fullback, Calvin Robinson here. The lead back. He gets the chop block there that opens it up. Now Bush gets a block on Noblin, and now it's Don Smith. This guy is just fun to watch. Cutting back against the grain, against an aggressively pursuing Mississippi's defense, and Stevon Moore drags him down from behind.
Stevon Moore has incredible speed. Remember, Don Smith runs about a 4.5 40, and Stevon Moore just came really trucking in from behind to catch him. Not until Smith took it to just outside the 35-yard line. First down, Bulldogs. Not much footing that time for Rodney Peters. You could see him skating as he went across the 35. Robert Smith knocks him down. There you go, over 100 yards now for Don Smith. 106 and 17 carries. He's passed for 18. Remember, if Don Smith goes more than 277 yards of total offense today, he will become the SEC's all-time leading career total offense player in the history of the conference.
That couple looks too dry, too happy.
They were in a studio in Atlanta. Yeah. I don't think they were really here. That's not a shot of the real football fans who are grimly getting through today's game. Second down 9. Delay out of the backfield. Some hard yards to the 32 for Calvin Robinson. It'll bring up third down and about 5.
I think it was Rodney Lowe that really put the hammer on him. You know, that's, you see Rocky Felker trying to work some inside. Our camera people are operating under adverse conditions.
Well, section 205, that's in the end zone. I would tell you who that camera operator is, but we can't say. That's Kevin Powley, who's undercover there. We talk about our booth conditions. We're dry. Well, we're sort of dry. That's where it's tough out there with the camera position. Third down 7 from the 32. Look at this. Still short of the first down, though. Don Smith was trapped back at the 35, and he gets it to the 28-yard line. Ben Morris and Mike Fitzsimmons finally combining to stop him.
And Lopez Jones fighting to stay on his feet to maintain containment. He must have been nicked on that play. He's coming off the field.
And we have a clock stoppage. It is not timeout charged to either team yet, I don't believe. Nobody has signaled that there is a charged timeout here. You're overlooking at the injured player. Let's see if we can spot what happens here, Tim.
He cuts it back upfield. Fitzsimmons in pursuit, number 71. Ben Morris is there. And Jeff Harrod. Bumped horns with Jeff Harrod, and I think that...
They're trying to get
what state
back
are you in? Do you know what town this is? That type of thing. That's a conversation right there.
Well, let's hope that young man's all right. We'll be back in just a moment to Jackson, Mississippi. Today's game is being brought to you by Coors and Coors Light. Beers with a difference worth tasting. 5:21 to go, third quarter, Memorial Stadium, Jackson, Mississippi. Ole Miss leading the Bulldogs 17-3. Don Smith is going to be okay. Mississippi State did have to use a timeout, though, as they went longer than the officials would allow them to try to get Don Smith back in there. And you can bet that he's woozy, even though he's back in, Tim Foley. He took really a pop.
He did, and Rocky talked to him, and Strat Karatasis, the head trainer from Mississippi State, was talking to him, and he wouldn't be back in there if they didn't feel like he could make some decisions.
Fourth down 3. Smith keeps it. He doesn't get it. Denied the fourth down conversion attempt by a stingy, stubborn defensive line. Mike Fitzsimmons, 71, 88, Lopez Jones there for Ole Miss. We're going to go back to our studios in Atlanta now. Here's Kevin Slayton. Thank you very much, Bob. Michigan State has scored again, and it's Robert Morse once more. This time he stumbles in 11 yards for the touchdown, his second of the day. Missed the point after they lead it 20-13 in the third quarter. Now back to Jackson, Mississippi.
We'll keep you updated on all the scores around the nation all afternoon. Stay with us here on our coverage of SEC football. Good low, nowhere. May have lost a little bit of yardage on the first and 10 from the 27. 5 minutes to go, third quarter here in Jackson.
96, Michael Simmons on the tackle.
Goodloe's been a workhorse since Sean Sykes had to go out of the ball game. Goodloe now with 18 carries, 66 yards. Sykes had 69 yards and 5 carries and injured his left knee and left the game in the first half. Second and 10 from the 27. 25, Myers to the left side. Willie Green, number one, to the right side. The split ends for the Reds. And they wanted to toss it very quickly to Willie Green. It was batted out of the air by Cedric Course, 53.
That's the type of play that you're counting on that defense to be coming upfield, penetrating, and you just want to pop it in over the top. Try to catch the contain man coming up. Batted down by Cedric Course, who is leading tackler from the Bulldog defense.
True freshman flanker number 9, Bobby Martin from Laurel, Mississippi, goes in the ball game. Mark Young hasn't attempted but 6 passes, but has 93 yards and a touchdown thanks to the 40-yard catch and run by Ambrose earlier. Third and 10. Here goes Ambrose for not much at all. Kirby Jackson stopped. Like to punt the ball away. It's the footing out there, as you can see very clearly, penalty marker there on the left side of your screen. The footing is, when you have the high camera shots, you can see that the field is not as green as it appears from the ground level. It is very, very muddy and wet seen here. Penalty against Ole Miss. And the footing becoming more treacherous, so we may see a whole lot of three downs and outs here. The Rebels in command of the ball game as of now, 17-3, unless Mississippi State can find some way to loosen up this defense. The only offense, as Tim had pointed out earlier, there's the penalty against Ole Miss, back to the 14. The only offense has been Don Smith for the Bulldogs.
Red ball foul, personal foul, offense.
That's
4
personal fouls today against Ole Miss.
The kicking game has been a big part of the last 3 games that these two teams have played. Big punt returns, big kickoff returns by Mrs. Oh, no.
Bill Smith gets leveled, but they must have also touched the ball. And at the 48-yard line, he goes down. Actually, it's because the ball became live, I guess. But there was no penalty on the play. He got the punt away. We'll be back in just a moment. Ole Miss 17, Mississippi State 3. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT.
Next week.
In 1974, the Egg Bowl was all Mississippi State. The 9-2 Bulldogs were led by their quarterback, the SEC Player of the Year, Rocky Felker. He had 2 rushing touchdowns, helping power State to an easy 31-13 victory and a berth in the Sun Bowl, where the Bulldogs went on to defeat North Carolina by a score of 26-24, but they were led by their SEC Player of the Year, and now the head coach, Rocky Felker. Seen in his rain gear. And not happy at the moment. Don Smith has a man open. Nice grab by Robinson inside the 35 to the 33. Smith with the tackle.
That's a good catch in the desert. Much less on a day like today. Look at this. Nobody likes to extend back over the middle. They don't like to reach out and grab those high balls. And this is not Smith's primary target. And once again, I think they feel like they can go deep, but he spots, he finds Calvin Robinson. What a catch! He's come up with some key blocks this afternoon and a big catch there.
Now, Don Smith is only 131 yards away from breaking that SEC total offense record. Arad stopping Calvin Robinson there. Don Smith has rushed for 111 and now thrown for 37. So it's possible that he could still break that, particularly through the air, as they have to start throwing here, trailing 17-3 with 3:14 to go in the third.
We've seen him operating games where he got clumps of 70 or more at a time.
Hand off Robinson. Stacked up there. Robert Smith, number 34 again. Let's go back to our studios in Atlanta. Here's Kevin Slaky.
All right, Bob, Michigan is coming back at Columbus. Watch Jamie Morris. Watch this move on the corner. He's the younger brother of Joel Morris of the New York Giants, and he may be headed to the NFL himself. 14-13. Bo didn't go for two in the tie this time. Now let's go back to Jackson.
Well, there. I'm warmer now. Third down five here, Mississippi State at the 28 of Ole Miss. Don Smith looking for running room, finding nothing but mud. Down at the 30. That was third down and seven, so it'll be fourth down, and the Bulldogs will go for it again, trailing 17-3.
You know, he makes a living on 90-degree angle cuts, and they're awful tough to make in a field like that.
There's Mike Fitzsimmons. You know, I believe that Fitzsimmons and Harrod and some of these Ole Miss players may like this mud.
Yeah, right. I know Fitzsimmons does. You can just tell by looking at him.
His neighborhood had no mud because it was all pavement. Timeout, Bulldogs. This will take them down to only one timeout remaining. Let's look at some scores now around the nation college football today. After Holy Cross got out to an early lead, Boston College headed for the Hall of Fame Bowl down in Tampa against Georgia, just clobbering. And look at this, Wake Forest coming from behind to take the lead in the fourth over Georgia Tech. And Penn State having very few problems with Pittsburgh today, third quarter, although Pittsburgh's still in the game. South Carolina with an upset in the making at halftime, 21-18 over Clemson. Texas A&M, bowl-bound, walloping TCU. North Carolina and Duke are tied in the second quarter. Let's look at some scores around the nation, and the very wet but spirited Mississippi State band. 1:45 to go third quarter.
This is the time of year people talk about bowls, and it's also the time of year that the coaching changes develop.
What have you heard? Have any rumors for us?
Well,
you're not moving out of the booth, are you? Look what Doug Collins did in the NBA. Moved out of the broadcast booth, went to Chicago. Now the Bulls are hot.
Was he sorry he did it?
But I'm not getting any commitment from Coach Foley here. I guess you'll stay with me. You like working with me too.
I know one job that's open is Louisiana Tech, and Carl Torbush, who's a very, very highly thought of coach in the SEC, the defensive coordinator here, is talking to those folks.
On fourth and seven, the Bulldogs are going to go for it again. They have not converted on a fourth down play all day, and don't on this one. John Lowe, the intended receiver, down at the 25. Your alma mater, Purdue, replacing Coach Burnett, and several names have been mentioned for that job, coaches. How about any inside information there, Tim?
Don't really have any inside. Now, there's some talk to those people up there, and told them about a couple guys I thought would be pretty good, but I'm not sure exactly what they're thinking.
First down 10 from the 30-yard line. Ole Miss leading 17-3. 1:41 to go in this ballgame. Mark Young, now he's under some pressure. Gets rid of the ball. Incomplete out there at the 47-48-yard line. It was intended for 25, Ricky Myers. Some of those Mississippi State offensive ball players. Next week, we'll be bringing you the great rivalry between Georgia Tech and Georgia from Athens, Georgia. Both of those teams potentially headed to bowls. Georgia's going down to the Hall of Fame Bowl. Some people were talking about Georgia Tech going to possibly the Blue Bonnet Bowl. They are losing right now, by the way, Georgia Tech to Wake Forest, 24-21. Second down 10 from the 30. Winner of this game will head to the Independence Bowl in Shreveport. Hand off to 41 Mickles. Not much yardage there. That's the story of this game. What'll his mama think?
Everybody looks like a lineman in this game, don't they? Who's that? Is that Stan Sims?
I believe it is 66, yes. Right guard. Bulldogs.
Been a leader in that offensive line for Tom Goode. Played hurt part of the year. And They lost Jerome McLaurin early on, and Irwood Minor has had problems with injuries all year long. And last week, all they had suited up was seven offensive linemen.
Third down, six from the 34. Ole Miss leading 17-3. Clock winding down in the third quarter with 45 seconds remaining. Mark Young is going to be nailed at the 30. Original line of scrimmage. Michael Simmons, number 96, is there to get him. And Bill Smith will come in to punt the football away again. Last time, Bill Smith was credited with a 57-yard punt. We figured it up, and it traveled about 70 yards in the air. Went through the end zone and out, so he only get 57. He's averaging 47 today. Third in the SEC in punting stats. He's a returning All-American, but has slumped as a punter this year, as he'd be the first to tell you. Michael Robinson is deep. He's breaking out of his slump today. That one not so far, but it's long, it's loose, and it's covered by Robinson, then knocked out of bounds. It will belong to Mississippi State at about the 21-yard line. That's the end of the third quarter. Back in a moment, Rebels leading 17-3.
I don't know. What are you going to do?
I don't know.
I'd go to college.
Me too.
If I had the money.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do?
I don't know. What are you going to do?
You don't want those fries.
What are you going to do, Jack? Eat your way to college?
Really? I'm going to college on the new GI Bill. You serve full-time in the armed forces or part-time in the reserves, and you earn a lot of money for tuition.
The new GI Bill.
Are you using that pickle?
Now for young men and women in the armed forces, it's a great place to start. See your local recruiter.
For over 80 years, the name Buick has stood for enduring values in this country, and that is still true. Because when it comes down to what really matters on some cold, wet morning, when you settle behind the wheel and touch the key to the ignition, that is when you come to know the reliability that goes into making a car like this Buick Park Avenue special. Consider it, not because it's perfect, but because it's so good at the things that really count. Buick, where better really matters.
This is Super Football Saturday on TNT.
You're on the 10 o'clock American flight?
The meeting's this afternoon.
Seems like you're busier than ever.
Dad, I'm glad you could stop by.
Wish I had more time. Now, when did you say you were planning on coming home again?
Not until the end of the term.
You know, I don't think I can wait that long.
When you're something special, people know it.
My husband's a sweetheart, but he can't remember a thing. That's why I got him a Casio Data Bank watch and Casio Data Calculator. What's your phone number, Walter?
555-0700.
When's our anniversary?
Tomorrow.
Very good, Walter.
To remember card numbers, access codes, up to 50 things, get a Casio.
Now Walter can forget about having to remember anything. Almost.
Casio.
You're watching Superstation, WTBS.
The fourth quarter from Jackson, Mississippi. Ole Miss 17, Bulldogs of Mississippi State 3. On first down 10, Bulldogs, about 3 yards.
RCA, that's exactly what you'll get.
Well, the rain's starting to fall very hard once again. Rocky Felker not having himself an enjoyable day on the wrong end of a 17-3 Ole Miss lead. First and 10 for the 40 Rebels. Goodlow is going to run it again. Across the 45, with the 46 and out of bounds. Bruce Plummer chasing him. Rocky Felker got this team off to an excellent start, then ran into a murderer's row of the SEC, LSU, Alabama, and Auburn, starting with Auburn, actually, and lost three in a row by tremendous differences in score. And now here he is at the wrong end of a 17-3 Rebel score, and it has been since the fourth quarter of that Auburn game back in October since Mississippi State has even scored a touchdown. Second down three, Rebels. Goodlow did not get to the first down marker. It'll be third down. Michael Simmons with the stop.
We had a good thing happen last night in Mississippi. Rodney Triplett's dad, Calvin, And the Picayune Maroon Tide football team last night upset the number 2 ranked Moss Point High School. Double overtime, 28-27. Way to go, Calvin, and those folks down at Picayune. Rodney could hardly talk today. Rodney, was it a good game?
Oh, yeah.
Third down and one. Penalty markers down. It was Anthony Butts who came off for Mississippi State, number 92. Was he drawn off, however? That's what, of course, Mississippi State's saying. One of the most oft-argued points in football on these kinds of plays. Man in the white hat, Rom Gilbert, SEC official. .12:47 remaining in this one. It's pouring rain again. Offsides, Bulldogs. Bringing a cheer from the... I'll tell you what, this crowd, just see how wet it is over there. Is that guy blowing up a raft? I think the raft is about to...
Uh-oh. Here comes the tail.
Defense, contact with me.
Maybe it's not a raft. It's like a Godzilla. We've seen it all here today, folks, and that's what we mean. The folks who are wet in this ball game and our football fans are just enjoying the rain now. It's beyond trying to stay dry. You're going to go with the flow. On first down.
Got it.
What a play! It's picked off by Bruce Plummer. Plummer to the 49-yard line of Mississippi State. Willie Green had him beat. It was 6 points, 34-yard return. And there's a penalty marker down, but it was after the interception. What a play.
They tried to catch Bruce Plummer sleeping. Willie Green, a real speedster for Ole Miss, lined up wide on the left side of your screen, started to sprint down the left side. He's got it. The ball is underthrown. Plummer plays the ball beautifully, makes the catch, and regains his footing and heads upfield. Bruce Plummer, a 4-year starter for the Bulldogs here. Talked about it earlier. Another real fine man-to-man coverage person. Mark Young just doesn't get it out there far enough. Willie Green's got it. When someone's that open, you have a tendency to become conservative. You don't want to miss him, but Bruce came back and made a tremendous play on the ball.
Bruce, a senior from Bogalusa, Mississippi. They moved the ball back to the 30-yard line. It had gone near midfield, but the penalty marker went down. They mark off 10 for holding against Mississippi State. It'll be Bulldogs ball when we return.
Better than this.
Well, it's a foul day for man and beast alike.
That's right. Well, you know we're known for movies here at TBS, right?
We call that used to be a black and white gorilla, or Godzilla there until we colorized it for you. We have 12 minutes, 27 seconds left in this game. I can't tell who that is being aided from the field there for Mississippi State. Could it be Calvin Robinson? He was shaken. Oh, it's one of the officials. Excuse me. One of the officials whom we did not see go down is being taken off the field. Let's see if we can identify who that is. I believe someone said it was the line judge. I won't try to identify him because I do not know him by face, but the line judge is Ronnie Baines. At any rate, I don't know if that's him, but he is injured and being helped from the field. Going into the dressing room now here at Jackson. It's Bert Ackerman is the injured official. Norbert Ackerman, excuse me. He is the linesman, not the line judge. And there is a standby official, Tommy White. He will go into the ball game. We hope he'll be all right. We'll check on the official, Norbert Ackerman, and let you know what his condition is. Looked like he was shaken up on one of those plays. Don Smith going to the air. He's going for everything. Hadley's out there. It's almost picked off by Stevon Moore. Intended for Fred Hadley.
Stevon Moore in good shape, makes his move in front of Hadley. Once again, if that ball had been thrown a little harder, but it's a tough catch. You know, you have to look through this rain to see the ball coming down.
Rain is driving now. Second down, 10 from the 30. Rebel 17, Bulldogs 3. Smith go to the air again. Shorter pass this time, incomplete at the 39-yard line. Wanted to go to Hadley, and there was Stevon Moore to jar him loose from the ball.
Hadley breaking to the outside here, and Smith throws the ball back toward the defensive back. You'd like that ball as a receiver thrown back toward the line of scrimmage.
So it'll be third down, 10. Same receivers in the ball game. John Lowe, Fred Hadley. Lowe's 84, Hadley's 25.
Here come Harrod and Smith.
Spreading out, though, Don Smith has a man open. It's Hadley. It is incomplete. Knocked loose at the point of reception at the 43 by Stevon Moore. And Don Smith trying to put some yards up there. He's thrown 17 passes. Only four have been completed for only 36 yards.
Is it Hadley on the receiving end there? Yeah, gives him a little out and up move. He's got him whipped. He falls down. Smith sees him drifting back inside, delivers the ball, makes the catch, and Stevon Moore knocks it out. So how you say that's a long, way, complicated way to say it. That's an incomplete pass. That's how that goes down in the book.
Here's Tommy Parks with the Bulldogs punt. He gets away a few. It's going back to Myers. Inside is 20, and he's not going to get outside either. Stepped out of bounds at the 18-yard line. We'll be back in just a moment. It'll be Ole Miss football, but now let's go to our studios in Atlanta and Kevin Slate.
All right, Bob, Michigan has taken the lead for the first time in the Battle for the Roses. Jamie Morris again, straight up the middle, power running. Great desire to find the end zone for Morris. They went for two this time, didn't make it. Bowl may never do it again. 1917 Michigan. Let's go back to Jackson.
Well, that's set up for a heartbreaker with a two-point lead.
Oh, boy.
At Columbus, what a ball game that one's turning out to be today. Rebels 17, Bulldogs 3 here in Jackson, Mississippi. 11 minutes, 53 seconds remaining in this game. It's Rebels football. Out to about the 23-yard line goes Willie Goodlow, number 24, tackled by Course.
Don Smith trying to stay warm, trying to stay a little dry.
Don has thrown for 36 yards. I told you, only four out of 17. He's hit his target several times. The ball been dropped in these sloppy conditions, and thanks to some intense defense by Ole Miss. And Don has rushed today for 109 yards. Second down, 5. Driving close to the first down, but short is Willie Goodlow, and Course on the stop again. North Carolina State has defeated Western Carolina, the Fighting Catamounts of Western Carolina. Missouri leading Kansas in the third. Temple ahead of Rutgers. Wonder how Paul Palmer is doing today in the third quarter. We'll try to check that for you. 24-21 North Carolina leading Duke now. Northwestern over Illinois, 14-3. Second quarter, Illinois beat Indiana last week. Air Force ahead of Rice in the second.
Northwestern beat Michigan State, didn't they? Northwestern going for two in a row. Look out.
Goodlow goes down, and he is short of the first down. Anthony Butts with the tackle.
What happened here now? We got a little flag.
May have been, there was a lot of celebrating going on back there in the Mississippi State defensive side. Here's Rom Gilbert to tell us what happened. Illegal participation is the signal. Too many men on the field. I believe they had too many men on the field. And it's a big penalty. I guess if they put too many men on the field, they have to penalize you pretty big.
Illegal participation. Defense. 12 men participating.
So after the good third down play by the Bulldogs, when a day when nothing's going very well for them, it becomes a first down for Ole Miss, and there's the story of the Bulldogs' attitude at the moment. First and 10, Ole Miss. Goodlow. The block. Can't turn the corner, though. Got only a couple. Wrapped up by 45, Willie Monroe.
But he did get the block from Joe Mickles, and Mickles is really an unsung hero here. Mickles cut down Brian Hudson, who is coming up for support for the Bulldogs, and I think that Mickles has as much to do with the resurgence of Ole Miss's ground game as anyone. That fullback is so important. He's the man that gives you the time to make the move, to find the opening. He's the man that's going to help you penetrate the perimeter by knocking down that contained defender.
Second down, 8 from the 44-yard line. Young gives to Mickles. He has an opening, but he doesn't get the first on this play. He's going to come down short of the first, about the 49-yard line. Dwayne King and Cedric Corse combining on the play. There's Mickles. We've been talking about the Egg Bowl all day. It's all for that trophy. It's put together in 1927. As you can see, it's a gold football. They used to call it the Battle for the Golden Egg. I often wondered why they didn't call it the Battle for the Golden Football, since it's not an egg.
It would have been very uncreative of them, wouldn't it? So back in those days, that's how a football looked, too.
1927. The series started in 1901. This is the 83rd meeting today. Third down, 2. And the Bulldog defense stops Goodloe. Michael Simmons there again. Now, if they didn't have the 12 men on the field, then Ole Miss will have to give up the ball, and that's going to be the case. In comes Bill Smith, averaging 47.6 yards per punt today, had one of 57 yards.
Simmons has covered some ground this afternoon. An exceptional job up front. Big play man for Mississippi State's defense.
Back deep, 34, Milton Smith. Penalty marker down. Ball takes an Ole Miss bounce. Smith is going to try to get outside, but tripped up inside the 20-yard line. Down quickly, number 86, James Smith, to make the play. Penalty markers down. Only a 38-yard punt that time. Illegal participation, Mississippi State again. Too many men on the field. Well, that'll be another big mark off. The line of scrimmage was at the 50.
That's something that you spend a lot of time on in practice. Game situations, going through game situations in practice, running people in, running people off. What if this man is hurt? Who goes in then? And it's really got to be discouraging for Rocky.
It's a 15-yarder and a first down. It moves it to the 35. That's 30 yards on this drive after two excellent third down plays.
Defense, 12 men participating.
It happened to Mississippi last week against Tennessee, and talking to Torbush about that, he said Howard Moss had been knocked silly, really wasn't sure where he was. The flag was on the ground by the time he really woke up and realized that he wasn't supposed to be in there. Those things happen occasionally. You just hate to see them happen at critical times like this when you're trying to fight your way back into a football game.
So now it's first down 10 at the 35-yard line. Joe Mickles doesn't get much, tackled by Dwayne King. There have been three Ole Miss first downs in this half, and all three have been via the penalty route.
So the Mississippi State defense has really come on and stood up in this half.
They have played well. The last time a touchdown was scored was with 13:34 left in the second quarter. So it's just after the beginning of the second quarter. Since then, only the two field goals. And it's 17-3, Ole Miss leading with 7:24 to go in the game. It is now second and 10 from the 35. Big opening. It is Reed Hines. Touchdown, Ole Miss. Reed Hines steps into the ball game. Hines is a freshman flanker from Milton, Florida.
Think he's excited? Watch Mickles here. Good job of blocking. Reed Hines, eyes back inside. Adam Seck opens the hole up back inside. Irvin doing a good job and looking back to the middle. Paid off for Reed Hines, who dives into the end zone, and he won't come down for a while.
He was playing that flanker position, lining up kind of on a wing as J.R. Ambrose does often. The point after is good, and it's 24-3 Ole Miss. They've tried that play a couple of times with Ambrose, so Hines kind of sneaked into the game and now has scored the touchdown. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT. Well, Ole Miss has dominated this series 47-29, and the Ole Miss mascot holding on tightly to the Egg Bowl trophy as Rocky Felker talks to Don Smith. It's not going to go back to Starkville again this year. 24-3, Rebels lead. Lewis Clark, 82 at the one. And Clark gets it out here to the 32-yard line, and down he goes with 7 minutes remaining in this ball game.
Now, Billy Brewer has, as a player and as a coach, has never lost to the Mississippi State Bulldogs. He's 3-0 as a coach, about to be 4-0, and as a player, I believe he was 2-0-1. So Billy Brewer has yet to taste the bitter pill of defeat from the Mississippi State Bulldogs.
There's that drive, 82 yards in eight plays, 35-yard TD run by Hines. He'd actually touched the ball a couple of times on kickoff and punt returns, but had never touched the ball from the line of scrimmage prior to that 35-yard touchdown run, one of which he will remember for his entire life. It's complete to Clark out at the 40, short of the first down. Jonathan Shelley with the stop. 6:49 remaining in this ball game, and that's 45 yards in the air now for Don Smith. 154 yards on the day. He needed 277 to take over the all-time SEC total offense championship.
Mississippi with five defensive backs in the game now, Bob.
Six. I was going to say six until Mike Fitzsimmons jumped off sides there, 71. He actually went into the other backfield. I know that Fitzsimmons has been getting a quick start on the ball, but that one just a little bit too quick today.
You know, sometimes a player will pick up a key, something that comes an instant before the ball is snapped. I know that Bob Kuchenberg picked something like, was an all-pro for the Dolphins, had a key on Alan Page, and by the way he lined up, he could tell which way he was slanting. And we always had a lot of luck against Minnesota, and it might just be a small thing that gets you off a fraction of a second before the offense has a chance to move, and it really negates the advantage that the offensive man has knowing the snap count.
Well, there's a final. Wake Forest upsets Georgia Tech 24-21. Don Smith going long. He's got Lewis out there. Lewis never saw the ball. Lewis Clark was down there at about the 10-yard line looking to his right. The ball was to his left. And Lewis Clark never did have his eye on the ball.
Rocky Felker's got the right idea. I think the way to attack this Mississippi defense is over the top. They're very aggressive, very upfield, and they the way they play, their people have to play man-to-man a lot. And that time, there was nobody on the tight end, and Lewis Clark was behind the secondary.
6 minutes remaining in this ball game. It is second down 10, and Don Smith, going to the air regularly now, completes this one to Robinson. Robinson is short of the first down, tripped up at the 50, falls forward to the 46. Jeff Arad will get credit for the tackle. And it'll be third down 3 now. Third and 3 from the 46-yard line.
This Mississippi style of defense, Carl Torbush upfield attack, is really almost the antithesis of what you'd see from Joe Kynes at Alabama. Very conservative, softer style of defense. Don't give up the big play.
Five defensive backs for Ole Miss. Jonathan Shelley is the nickelback on third and 3. Don Smith calling timeout, and that is the final timeout for the Mississippi State Bulldogs. Things weren't together. Don Smith had no other choice. 5:11 to go in the game. Five minutes, 11 seconds to go in this ball game, and Billy Brewer has been under a lot of pressure all year, as has this Ole Miss program investigated by the NCAA for recruiting violations. They've had an internal Ole Miss investigation. A lot of personal tragedies for the families of some of these players. They've overcome those things to head to 7 wins on this season. Pass intended for Lewis Clark. And Ole Miss on their way to a bowl game. They will be going to the Independence Bowl in Shreveport. versus Texas Tech. Don Smith ending his great collegiate career.
And he has been an exciting player for Mississippi State, brought a lot of enjoyment to the Bulldog fans over his 4 years, throwing the football, making the big play, turning the scramble into a touchdown, taking a beating week after week after week, but he lines up every week and performs.
On fourth down, going to go for it again. Incomplete. Intended for Lewis Clark. But Clark was being wrestled to the ground by Joe Nathan Shelley. Could not hold on to the ball. And it'll go over to Ole Miss. Ole Miss will now try to run clock. 5 minutes remaining in this game, and it's Rebels 24, Bulldogs 3. 25 pass attempts for Don Smith today. Only 6 completions. He's hit his target. They have not been able to hold on to the ball for a multitude of reasons. Mississippi State tried to convert fourth down into first down 4 times in this half. They have been unsuccessful all across the board. Milking the clock with an audible. Hines and Dentley in the backfield. Here's Reed Hines again. His second collegiate carry, not as successful as his first, a 35-yard touchdown run, only 1 yard that time. Gary Frank with the tackle. That's a look at the Bulls on TBS New Year's Eve. Paul Hornung will join Tim Foley and myself for the Florida State-Indiana ball game. Indiana losing 10-0 to Purdue at halftime today. Florida State plays Florida next week. The Aloha Bowl, Arizona and the leftovers. And there, it's a season of leftovers, folks. Blue Bonnet Bowl, Baylor and Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech upset by Wake Forest today. Cotton Bowl will have the Southwestern Conference champion versus the runner-up in the Big Ten. We'll come back to that in a moment. Reed Hines to the 45, short of first down, tackled by Bruce Plummer. And that will be the loser of the Michigan-Ohio State game. Michigan leading right now late in that game. We'll keep you updated on that one going on in Columbus. Fiesta Bowl, Miami-Penn State. That's the controversial bowl that's been moved to January 2nd for the number two teams to play for number one. $2.5 million payoff. The Florida Citrus Bowl is Auburn-Southern Cal. That ought to be a pretty good ball game. That had some controversy, too, because the Citrus is where Auburn went, and then the Orange Bowl offered Auburn an opportunity, but that diet already accepted in the Citrus. Now, of course, nothing can be official until after today's games, so we call those unofficial, but most of these deals have been basically made. The Freedom Bowl, UCLA versus the runner-up in the Western Athletic Conference. The Gator, Clemson, and Stanford could be a good one. Clemson was losing to South Carolina earlier today. Hall of Fame Bowl, good matchup. Georgia and Boston College. Boston College just clobbering Holy Cross today. Georgia off, getting ready to play Georgia Tech next week. Holiday Bowl, WAC champion versus Iowa. Independence, Texas Tech versus, it'll be Ole Miss here, the winner of this game. Ole Miss leading 24-3. The Liberty, Minnesota versus the Tennessee-Kentucky winner. Haven't seen an update on that Tennessee-Kentucky score recently. We'll look into it a little bit later. 18 bowls.
That's a bunch.
There were 19 sanctioned for this year until the
Cherry
Bowl went under.
The one thing that didn't happen this year, we didn't get to Baton Rouge, and as a result, we didn't get to go to Phil's Oyster Bar and eat oysters and talk to
the
Piazza family down there. Have to make room for that in the offseason.
You may have to see LSU as they play in the Sugar Bowl. They could play in the Sugar Bowl, depending on how the SEC race finishes. Alabama plays Auburn yet, of course. Tony Dentley, the ball carrier.
What do you think is going to happen if Alabama is able to beat Auburn and they tie with LSU for the title? What do you think is going to happen then? Who's the Sugar Bowl going to take?
Well, I think they'd have to take LSU, being that LSU defeated Alabama. But let's face it, Alabama is one of the most attractive football teams in the nation in terms of national ratings for television. Could be a tricky pick. My prediction is they'd have to take LSU. What do you think? Reed Hines, nowhere this time.
Brian Hudson loses his helmet there. Do they have to take anybody? Or is that just pretty much their choice?
It is the definite choice of the Sugar Bowl. Generally, the sunshine starting to peek through here, so Air Foley may not be grounded after all, although the skies are still pretty cloudy. And the Ole Miss fans feeling real good about that sunshine. Mississippi State, they just don't care on the wrong end of this 24-3 score. The Sugar Bowl decides, so if it's a tie, they can pick who they want. Normally, they would pick the team higher ranked. LSU right. should probably end up, if Alabama were to beat Auburn, LSU would probably still end up higher ranked.
Depending on what happens against Notre Dame, I guess, this weekend and
exactly.
Tulane the next week.
Exactly.
It has been a crazy year. You know, as you laid down the choices of what might happen, you say, well, this could happen, that could be that. It probably never happened. And everything that probably would never happen happened.
You got that right. And the Ole Miss folks have joined our cameraman, Kevin Pally, up there. I hope they have enough support underneath section 205 in the end zone. Minute 10 to go in this ball game. It is going to be fourth down and three. And Ole Miss just letting that clock run, the play clock down to about 12 seconds and ticking inside a minute. We have a really good ball game for you at 12:30 Eastern time next week, and that's Georgia Tech, Georgia at Athens. Here's Reed Hines again. To about 33, 34 yard line. Did he get the first down? If he did, it'll just remain in the possession of Ole Miss. Mississippi State cannot stop the clock because they are out of timeouts. The executive producer for TBS Sports is Don Ellis. Today's game has been produced by Skip Ellison, directed by John Bishop. Technical director Rick Rayford, associate producer Rodney Triplett, still celebrating the big Picayune victory. Associate director Mark Zeman, who's done a great job all year, and the rest of our fine TBS crew, most of whom are very wet and surly today, but doing an excellent job. I know I'm wet and surly, so I would feel they probably are that way. 45 seconds remaining in this game, and Ole Miss is going to take their record now to 7-3-1 and head to the Independence Bowl. Ole Miss did not get the first down, so Mississippi State will get the football back for a couple of plays. And Mississippi State will end their season with a 6-5 mark, and they will not be happy about it, but it is a better record than most thought Rocky Felker would have in his first year.
And their first winning season at Mississippi State in a long time. So I think Rocky's got to be happy with the... He would have really liked to come out with a victory here.
Don Smith going long. Receiver falls down. It's picked off. Don Price with the interception. Only 8 seconds tick off the clock. It's down to 37 seconds. And now with no timeouts for Mississippi State, Ole Miss will just fall on it a couple of times.
It's the type of ball you got to get up a little bit earlier. Price makes his fourth interception since taking over for Jonathan Shelley since Shelley's knee injury, and coming in and played well for him. A young Mississippi defense.
You know, interestingly, there will be another game played on this field tonight. It's Jackson State and Alcorn will play here tonight, and this field is a quagmire. I'd hate to have to try to play football. There's Langston Rogers, the sports information director of Ole Miss, who always does such a wonderful job helping us prepare for the ball games.
Always feeds as well, doesn't he?
Here's some finals. Wake Forest has defeated Georgia Tech 24-21 as this shot clock, play clock winds down and game clock winds down. Purdue beating Indiana. Kentucky losing to Tennessee. I hope you folks can read those. I couldn't keep up with them.
Basketball keeps slipping in. The shot clock.
I always, it looks funny to me when it says 25 seconds. It should be 24 seconds. This one's going to be history, and the 83rd meeting between Ole Miss and Mississippi State belongs to the Rebels of Ole Miss by a score of 24-3. They dominated the ball game from the very beginning, and Ole Miss heads to the Independence Bowl in Shreveport. This is Super Football Saturday on TNT.
Bowl invitations do not come out officially until 6 o'clock Eastern time, but we will try to guess as to where most of the teams will probably go for you. That coming up in just a few moments, so stay with us. And now let's go back to Jackson, Mississippi.
Student vice president of Ole Miss holding on to the Egg Trophy until Langston Rogers got his hands on it. And they're taking it over to the middle of the field now for some photographs. That's the Egg Bowl. That's the trophy symbolic of the victory between Ole Miss and Mississippi State, and now Billy Brewer, the head coach at Ole Miss, carrying that trophy back to Oxford where it will reside for another year as he's congratulated by Anthony Butts of Mississippi State. The final here, Ole Miss 24, Mississippi State 3, and Billy Brewer battled through a tough year to take his team to the Independence Bowl, and a job well done by the head coach of Ole Miss. Next week, we'll have the Yellow Jackets of Georgia Tech versus the Bulldogs of Georgia from Athens, 12:30 Eastern Time. Join us for that. Today's game has been brought to you by Buick and your Buick dealers. For traditional comfort, technical innovation, and for a real commitment to quality, come to Buick, where better really matters.
Brought to you on the Superstation by Delta Airlines, serving more than 100 cities in the U.S. and overseas. Delta gets you there with care. And by the people who make glass containers, naturally.
From a muddy Lambert Field within Memorial Stadium at Jackson, Mississippi, for our entire crew, Tim Foley, this is Bob Neal, saying so long from Jackson and reminding you that coming up next on most of these stations, stay tuned for the Football Action Report.
This has been a presentation of TNT.